but it's even nicer to know.
K-E-L-L-O-Good.
There's still some things you can't put a price on.
Kellogg's best to you.
If you want full office suite power at a word processor price, look no further than Corel WordPerfect Suite. Corel WordPerfect Suite includes an exceptionally intelligent word processor, an award-winning spreadsheet, amazing presentation graphics, plus business graphics and utilities, hundreds of fonts and thousands of clipart images. Corel WordPerfect Suite delivers office suite power at a word processor price.
Colorado head coach Rick Neuheisel, what a great year last year, but you work under Mission Possible this year. Tell us quickly about it.
Well, we want to do the best we can. We feel like the mission is the national championship, and if everything comes together and we stick together, it's possible.
Well, Brent, it's time to tee it up. Back up to you.
All right, opening Jack. Day. Thank you very much. Opening day, everybody, just a little bit jittery. Washington State served up notice that they're not backing away. They win the flip, and rather than deferring, they say, we'll take the ball. So it'll be the bare left foot of Jason Leslie opening up the season for the Colorado Buffaloes. And back deep, Dee Morincola and Kevin McKenzie for the Cougars. Underway in Boulder. Low, bouncing, high kick fielded by McKenzie. 10 for the Cougars, 15, 20.
Woo!
Jammed up at the 22. And now we'll get our first look this season at Ryan Leaf, who will quarterback the Cougars. His only start came in their final game against Washington. Extremely poised, they lost it down the stretch, but his final pass that day in Seattle in rain fell incomplete in the end zone. His Chili's backs and receivers keep an eye on number 5, Michael Black. They signed him out of Los Angeles Junior College. They need in this offense. Also, Corey Solomon a year ago, 71, has changed his name. Corey Withrow. He'll snap the ball now, and you'll watch Leaf on his first play of the game. It'll be Black behind the left guard. Not much doing. The defensive front now for the Buffaloes. We have mentioned Matt Russell, but notice only 6 names. That's because 5 defensive backs are going to start today for the Buffaloes. And here they are, paced by the free safety, the captain of that group, Steve Rosga.
Washington State plans to come in and use 3, 4, and 5 wide receivers within their first 2 series. Therefore, the nickel coverage, good game planning by Colorado.
Second down and 11. Washington's the motion receiver. Black again on a cutback for a couple. Third and long, and an obvious first passing play for Leaf with Ryan Olson, the nose man, being very active. Let's watch Russell in the middle here, Coach.
Well, you know, he is a run defender, and he would like him to run. Middle linebackers like him get upset when you throw the ball too many times. He 2 plays in a row, 2 runs in a row. He likes that kind of football.
Now it's 3rd and 8. What have you seen with young Leaf's right arm, Coach?
Well, they say he had a sore arm in training camp, but in pregame warm-up, it looked awfully good.
They stretch the field. 4 wide receivers. 3 to the left for Leaf. First pass fires, and it's complete at the 29-yard line. That's short of the first down. That's going to be 3 and out for the Cougars.
You know what? I think that's a good term to use, Brent. You say he fires. When that ball comes off his hands, it is humming. But yet he has the ability to put the touch on the pass as well.
Big story now is the punter.
Yes.
They had a great punter in Martin for years up in Pullman. Now a JC youngster. His first punt under this kind of pressure. Jeff Banks, 6 foot, 174 pounds. Let's see how many steps he takes.
Well, he averaged over 40 yards a punt in junior college last year, but this is a lot different situation. And he did a good job.
His ball sometimes turns over left to right. Not this time. Nunez, the freshman from Texas, with great speed. He's got it on the sideline. Nunez, 45. Nunez to the 43. A fine return by the freshman from Austin.
should never let him get outside your sprinters. He got outside contained. The ball was punted high enough, he should have been able to cover it. Poor tackling effort right there, good block, and he gets outside now with that real good speed. A true freshman touching the ball for the first time in his college career today on a punt return.
So it is Koy Detmer, his first series. His numbers, he was unbeaten when he went down with that knee injury.
You don't want to give them the ball in the plus territory like they're starting out.
And they'll run Troutman, Herschel Troutman, and he is stacked up big time in the middle at the 45-yard line. Dorian Booz and Shane Doyle were there for the Cougars.
Big Leon Bender, 91, very physical, didn't play last year, working over Kyle Smith, 52, knocks him back in the backfield, linebacker fills it.
So the Chili's backs and receivers for the Buffaloes now behind Detmer. Ray Carruth, let's keep an eye on number 21. Great speed. Detmer to throw for the first time. Over the middle, Lepsis the tight end at the 35, that's short of the first down. This is going to be third and short for Colorado, so the focus now is on this offensive line. Chris Nyeole is right next to the big man, Adam Reed. He grew up in Boulder, went to Northwestern, transferred back. Remember Stoltenberg, he started for 4 years. Big shoes for Reed to fill now. He's number 53 in the middle of the offense. Here he is with a third and one.
You can see when you get the ball, Colorado gets the ball inside. At least in the past, they've been very efficient putting points on the board.
Troutman on a slippy. Fumble! Washington State's got it! That was number four, Johnny Nansen, the senior linebacker who scooped up the fumble. I believe Detmer was slipping on the handoff just a touch. We'll see.
You know, in Washington State last year was plus in turnovers. They were winning football games. The second half of the season, they were minor turnovers, minus, and they were losing. See, he got his feet caught up, and I'll tell you why he got his feet caught up. Leon Bender, the big defensive tackle, knocked the offensive guard back into the backfield, and he stepped on the quarterback's foot, Detmer's foot.
The kind of start the Cougars wanted. They relished coming in here, a three-touchdown underdog. First and 10, the ball at the 42-yard line. Leaf with Black behind him. And again featuring Black. Got past the first tackler, kept battling for about a yard or two. Mau, the defensive end, 6'2", 300-pound junior.
See, and they brought Matt Russell, the inside linebacker, up inside, and that just broke the whole rhythm of that offensive play. A.J. Kristoff, the defensive coordinator for Colorado, says he's going to rotate 24 defensive players through the ballgame. And I think that's going to be part of the story in the third and fourth quarter. Washington State doesn't have that kind of depth, either offensively or defensively.
They go empty in the backfield. That's five wideouts now for Washington State.
They'd like to blitz this when they can. They're going to go man to coverage.
So they try to man up. Four-man rush. Quick fire, low, incomplete at midfield. Damon Wheeler, the defender for the Buffaloes at that left corner spot.
Ryan Leaf, no matter how poised he appeared to be yesterday and how much confidence, he's got to be a little bit nervous today, Brent. I mean, this was his first real go at it other than the end of the season last year.
Three wide receivers off to Leaf's left. And Black, a good receiver, slips out to the right.
Blitz.
Come with a blitz off it. Black has got it. He's the hot receiver to the 48. Short. It is three and out again for the Cougars.
Good defensive series. They have outstanding speed. An offensive player may look like he's going to advance the ball, but here comes the black jersey just flashing in to make the play. Great overall team speed.
Now let's see what the freshman Nunez can do again for the Buffaloes as he goes back deep. He's number 22. We'll see him before the day is over as also one of the very talented wide receivers here, Jeff Banks. And the Cougars set to gain some yardage in field position, if nothing else. This is a high, tough punt to handle. And Nunez makes the fair catch at the 9-yard line. Good-looking punt. First and 10, Colorado, but they're backed up on their own 9.
Long ago, an inventor came up with the assembly line, allowing a few people to make a lot of something. It was the model for efficiency. At Chili's, we pride ourselves for our inefficiency because we make each of the Big Mouth burgers by hand, grilled one at a time, by a person. And when you taste for yourself how good they are, you'll appreciate all the time we've wasted. Chili's fresh grilled Big Mouth burgers, monuments of inefficiency.
Bob and Judith Akers looked forward to the day they could retire to a little business by the sea. No easy project to take on alone. Fortunately, a Dean Witter broker was there to help them chart the proper course.
Each individual's dream is unique. So too must be our solutions.
Now the Akers not only have a place they can call home, others can too.
Be back at 10.
We'll leave the light on.
At Dean Witter,
we measure success one investor at a time.
It's the only one out there. And here it comes. Introducing the only compact pickup to offer a third door. Okay, folks. Show's over. Chevy S-Series, like a rock.
USC invades Illinois. Big Ten power Penn State hosts Louisville. More games featuring Florida State or Oklahoma. Part of an ABC college football doubleheader next Saturday.
Neuheisel, the Colorado offense around him. They'll sprint out now. I'm sure they set the play over on that sideline during that commercial break. They come right to the line. Detmer with Herschel Troutman behind him. Slot man, Carruth to his left, looks in that direction, goes far outside to the 15-yard line. That was good coverage that time by Brandon Moore, number 22. Down we go to Jackaroot.
Well, Brent, there's one youngster that hoped to be on the special teams here for Colorado, Tyrone Tiger Bussey. He came here as a highly touted freshman, and he suffers from leukemia. He's had two bone marrow transplants, and today he finally gets a chance to watch the game. Now, he played in the spring ball, but he went out of remission, and his family is listening at home, and Tiger wanted to pass his best. It's a big story, Brent.
It really is, Jack. We certainly send along our best. And Troutman being brought down by Johnny Nansen. He is the Cougar who recovered that fumble. Again, we see the speed, which is featured by those of you up in the Pullman and Seattle area who have followed the Cougars through these years. A couple of years ago, probably as good a defense as there was in college football overall. We saw some of that speed demonstrated again. This is a maturing defense right now.
Well, Bill Doba, the defensive coordinator, Brent, said he hasn't been able to do as much on defense in training camp because of injuries. So he's coming into this ball game playing it pretty basic with his 4-3 front and mixing in the coverages.
Third and six, Carruth, number 21, is slotted to the left. Quick snap, tight end over the middle for a first down.
They want to bring Matt Lepsis, the tight end, into the passing game a little bit more this year. He caught 25 balls last year. They say that's not enough. He's a big, strong guy at 6'5", 265 out of Frisco, Texas. Came to school here with a 3.8 GPA. He's an outstanding student. So, hey, they're going to put the ball in his hands.
McCarty replaces, or I should say comes in as a second tight end. Troutman behind the left side. The Cougars gang up on him on the 26, led by Darling. And since we mentioned Darling, he's the ringleader of this Cougar front seven, as we see the Chili's Grill and Bar defensive front seven. He's the main man. Nansen also has been very active. Leon Bender, who got his grades up. There now is the defensive secondary, and the Cougars are very confident this group can hold up, but it's a long four quarters at this altitude against a whole bunch of speedy receivers here. Second down now in seven.
They weren't lined up properly on defense. They got it lined up late.
Detmer off a play fake, throws high, incomplete because of a major pass rush from the right side of that defense. Shane Doyle was in on him.
They got into him. They were going to run a naked bootleg out the backside of that play, away from the action, but they didn't fool it. Here he comes, number 46, middle of your screen. Nothing that Detmer could do.
third and seven. And the Cougars defense, impressive so far in the early going. Their whole concern as a staff is stamina in that down four defensively through this ball game. They don't have a lot of backup strength. Bump and run on Caruth, and the flag comes down. There's 4 seconds left on the 25-second clock, so let's see what our officials have.
Dead ball. False start on the offense. We're still playing third down.
First game jitters. That'll make it just a little bit more difficult for the Buffs as the ball being brought back to the 21-yard line. So it becomes third and 12 for Neuheisel.
Washington State notoriously over the last 3 years has been tough to move the ball in that first quarter.
And Nebraska fans can tell you all about that last year. It was Washington State's best game of the year. Detmer firing high and incomplete. Savoy, the intended receiver, and Phil Savoy was juggling, and Shad Hinchin said, that's enough juggling, let's just take it out.
It looked like Shad Hinchin was on him early. It looked like the pass interference could have been called in this. It's a one-on-one situation. He gives him a little burst move, comes back at it. Now you see him hit him there a little bit early. They didn't see it. Batted away, good coverage. They better go deep on that guy early in the ballgame and back him off.
So Andy Mitchell, 5 blocked punts a year ago with Kevin McKenzie deep for the Cougars. This a major point of emphasis for Buffalo. The Buffalo is saying we cannot have 5 more punts blocked.
And he punted the ball in 2 steps as he does in practice. He didn't do that last year, got off a good punt.
McKenzie fumble! Colorado recovers! At the 26-yard line. So Coach Bobby Houck's special teams comes up with its 2nd big play of the day. Number 1, a fine return from Nunez. And Nunez, watch him get down the field.
McKenzie doesn't get under it properly. Yes, he's a younger player here, redshirt junior. Hasn't been back there a lot, but boy, you have to make that play. That is a big, big turnover. Look at the distance they've gained in field position.
Ryan Black recovers. Timeout.
Like a rock, I was strong as I could be. Like a rock, nothing ever got to me.
At the end of the day, there's only one full-size pickup that's best in initial quality.
Like a rock.
Chevy CK. It's a dirty job, but somebody's got to do it. To compete overseas, you can't go it alone. You need to be part of a team. A world-class competitor that's fast and well-trained. A team that knows the territory around the world. Global delivery services from the U.S. Postal Service. If you're going places overseas, ride with us. No one delivers like the U.S. Postal Service.
You've been thinking about getting a digital satellite dish. And thinking some more. Well, think about this. The people at Radio Shack can answer your questions. Plus, now they've got great deals. Own an RCA brand DSS dish with programming for about $1 a day plus installation. Up to 200 channels of select movies and sports available on USSB and DirecTV. Think about it. Better yet, stop thinking about it. Radio Shack, you've got questions, we've got answers.
College football on ABC Sports brought to you by Chevrolet Trucks, the most dependable, longest lasting trucks on the road. Chili's Grill and Bar, home of the Big Mouth Burgers. The Correll Corporation, makers of Correll Word Perfect Suite. And Dean Witter. There are many ways to measure success. Dean Witter measures success one investor at a time. The Rocky Mountain background here in Boulder, Colorado on a warm Saturday afternoon. Played on artificial turf with the heat being reflected. Koy Detmer and the Buffaloes will start from the 27-yard line after that fumble punt. This is Troutman, middle right. Troutman battles to the 16-yard line. close to a first down.
Well, you're running at the right place, right behind two big guards at 300 pounds and a nice center there, that, as you said, that just transferred back out of Northwestern. They pop it inside, and he has that great quickness, that low center of gravity, and he can pick daylight if it isn't right there in front of him.
It was 10 yards for the first down. This is what they accomplished inside the 20. They were prolific.
They were, and the percentage of touchdowns is really good, too. They're up above 60%.
Detmer and the Buffaloes with a chance here from the 16-yard line. First down pass up over the middle. Deep. Caruso got bobbled it incomplete.
Clever play. Clever play. Quarterback comes back, pumps, fakes the slant pattern to the left side of his offensive formation to draw the safety in that direction, then comes back and throws the post down the hole. It's just not a completed pass. Should have been caught. He doesn't drop many. You can see by this graphic, three of his nine touchdowns were over 70 yards. He has great speed. Here it is from up high. Now, right down the middle of the screen. See the pump fake to the left, and he lays it up high. Big hole in there. He's got to make that play. Too simple.
He goes slot left. Anderson's outside him. James Kidd, number two, brings the play in. Three wides, and they'll run Troutman. Huge hole on the left side to the 13. It closed quickly because of Mr. Darling. He's very active in the middle.
He is so quick. He runs with his feet parallel a lot, Brent, and he stutter steps. So therefore, he gets up behind the big rear end of one of those linemen. He sees a little space over to one side. Boom, he just shifts his body and gets there.
It will be third and eight. The ball is at the Washington State 14-yard line. Jason Leslie warm in case they need the field goal. Detmer back. Has time, lobs in zone, incomplete. It's field goal time for Jason Leslie and the Buffaloes. And Washington State dodges another six-point bullet. That's twice today that Colorado has had a first down in Cougar territory, and now they'll try to come away with at least 3 points.
Now, Jason Leslie is not a real experienced guy. He kicked off for him last year 77 times, but he only attempted two PATs and one field goal. He was one for one at 44 yards.
And the safety, Rosco, will put it down. It'll be a 31-yarder. Good. Colorado scores first. But it could have been a lot worse for Washington State than 3-0 right now.
This has got to be a confidence builder for young Jason Leslie. First one this year, only kicked one last year, and he pops it through. Not a real long one, but it doesn't matter. It's still 3 points and a boost for his ego. Talking to Coach Houck there, the special teams coach.
3-0, Colorado. And this, of course, the debut of Monday Night Football here on ABC coming up. We have an hour special at 8 Eastern time, and that is Monday Night Mania. Some of the heroes of past Monday nights will share their memories, and then you'll be able to watch the Dallas Cowboys. How are they going to do without Michael Irvin in Chicago against the Bears Monday night?
I think the Bears are going to play them real tough. You can't keep losing the players and experience the different problems that team has been experiencing and still be the caliber of team you were. If they can be, that's an education for me, Brent.
So Jason Leslie, the junior, puts the first 3 points of the year on the scoreboard for the Buffaloes. I wonder about Jason, don't you? Late in November here in Colorado, folks, that's got to be a tough right foot.
All throughout the conference, late in November could be a tough place to kick with that bare foot.
I think they go to Lincoln, Nebraska that last week in November. All the great fans over there can't wait to see the Buffaloes. Kevin McKenzie, hoping to make up for the turnover.
Good hit, got a good hang time.
And take a knee, says his teammate. Lorne Kohler tells him to kneel it down. So quite a story with the kicker here, Jack.
Well, Brent, last year they called him Kamikaze because of his work on special teams. Not the fact that he kicked off, but the fact that he was actually scored for a couple of tackles inside the 20. He loved to play on special teams and go headhunting. This year the coaches have said, uh-uh, you're responsible for place kicking as well as kicking off. You're going to be a cream puff now.
You notice how the field goal kicker went right over the special teams coach? He made it. When they don't make it, they always go the other way.
Here's the third series for Leaf. The Cougars offense not on track. Sean Timms, eight, the wing back in motion. This is Black. Hole this time, left side. And Black to the 24-yard line. So that's about as impressive a play as we've seen on first down for the Cougars so far, Coach.
Good basic draw play. They got Jones, the defensive end upfield, number 59. See, they get, oh, he's backing out in zone coverage. It was the linebacker that went up, and they created their own hole, outsmarting themselves on first down with that kind of a defensive call. They rushed the linebacker and dropped out the defensive end.
Second and six. Empty again. That's five wide receivers for Leaf. Russell shows blitz and he's coming. Picked up. Leaf. Incomplete. Almost intercepted. And the line judge says incomplete. It was bobbled by Dalton Simmons, the cornerback who is coming off knee surgery and missed all of last season.
A.J. Kristoff, defensive coordinator, Colorado's game plan versus empty is to rush five people and cover with six. And go man-to-man. He has tremendous confidence in the ability of his secondary to cover one-on-one, and therefore he rushes the fifth a rusher rather than dropping him in coverage.
Four-man front. Bump and run. Empty in the backfield. Five wide receivers. Blitz is coming. Quick fire. Oh, incomplete.
They knocked it down. They got
There's
to call
interference.
That.
Yes. It's an automatic first down and a 15-yard penalty as Kevin McKenzie was knocked down on the play. The corner on that side, Marcus Washington.
Ryan Leaf read the blitz, went to the slant receiver, the hot receiver coming inside. Marcus Washington just stepped up and gave him a shove. Automatic first down, as you said. Right?
Pass interference on the defense. Automatic first down.
You'll see this from the end zones. You'll see the inside linebacker there rushing up inside. That created the hole they were trying to get to, but there was contact made to the left side of your screen prior, so he couldn't make the catch.
But I was wrong on the other part of it. It's not 15 in addition to. It is just the first down at the 28-yard line. So Leaf now, two backs in, they're split in the backfield, two wide receivers, and they will run Merriweather around the right corner for about a yard or two.
They're going to have a hard time handing the ball off parallel to the line of scrimmage and then turning corners against this kind of speed. The best kind of plays are your traps and your draws. The one good running play they've run so far in the first quarter has been a draw.
There's a young man, folks, who grew up, well, he was a son of an Air Force sergeant, moved all around the world, and Russell, number 16, whom we just saw, was an outstanding soccer player growing up. And had it not been for football, he would have continued his career in soccer. But he is an outstanding middle linebacker. Second down and nine for the Cougars. Here comes the blitz. Picked up. Isolated one-on-one. Incomplete. He overthrew Sean McWashington, who was being covered by Teray Davis, number four.
Good, good coverage. And again, Ryan Leaf throwing the ball so easily, but he is so strong. I think he could overthrow a receiver from any point on the field, Brent. And being a little tight, maybe, and everything like that, putting a little bit too much muscle into his throw. You can see, ladies and gentlemen, how easy it is. He gets hit from the back. It's not going to bother this guy. He could line up and play tight end. He's big enough.
That's the safety who recovered the fumbled punt leading the field goal, Black, who came in on the safety blitz. Now it is Leaf and the Cougars, third and nine. Straight back, hit again on the release, incomplete. Savage pressure. The offensive line did not hold up that time.
Well, Greg Jones is an outstanding defensive end. He was a linebacker, and he has great speed. He's already graduated. Here he comes from the reverse side. He's coming from the left corner of your screen. Here he comes all the way around there. They're going to have to help the people assigned to block him one-on-one. They're going to have to give him some help, either with a chip by a running back or a tight end on that side.
Nunez back to return. Banks punt. His third punt. Nunez fields it at the 30-yard line. Got a clip. Not called. Cuts back into the middle at the 35-yard line. Timeout with Colorado leading by a field goal.
Introducing the all-new Chevy S-Series sports side. The coolest thing to come on the back of a truck since the Nutty Buddy. Chevy S-Series sports side, like a rock.
Inside your car's fuel system, there's a constant battle between good and evil. So if you have a dirty fuel system, none of these dark forces can match the power of STP Complete Fuel System Cleaner. STP's most technologically advanced fuel system cleaner ever. Dirt has met its match. STP Complete Fuel System Cleaner.
Some of the most admired cars you'll see are owned by the guys who know cars best. They're ASC certified master mechanics. And the number one brand of motor oil these guys use in their own cars and trucks is Valvoline, makers of DuraBlend, the leading semi-synthetic for a cleaner engine due to better control of harmful deposits. So use the oil the mechanics who take care of your car use to take care of theirs. Valvoline. People who know use Valvoline.
You'll see the sprinter coming down on right here, and then you'll see a blocker coming across, and we believe hit him in the back. The officials didn't see it the same way we saw it from up here. Here it comes from the right side of your screen. Boop.
Close. Yeah. First and 10 for Detmer and the Buffaloes. The ball at the 35. Rick Neuheisel, I don't think, expected this much difficulty against his high-octane offense here in the early going. Double tied in now, and two wideouts with one running back, Lindgren Henry, set in. Play fake Detmer. Fires one-on-one. Here's Carruth. Look out. Midfield. And Carruth to the 41-yard line on first down. The Buffaloes are in Cougar territory again.
Double tight end, good play action, and the linebacker, Johnny Nansen, came all the way off the line of scrimmage after the play fake and got in on that play. Excellent hustle by Johnny Nansen.
24-yard game. Detmer to Carruth.
Carruth is a first-team academic All-Big Eight as well as an All-American wide receiver, an outstanding student, engineering and education major.
There they go with the double tight end, two wide outs, and the one running back is Henry. Huge hole. Cuts back, slams across the 35-yard line, was juggling the ball as he was hit. See, but he came up with it.
They're pulling offensive linemen in their offense more this year than last year. That was a counter play, pulled both the guard and tackle through it. Sometimes they use the center. And in talking with Chris Nioli, the offensive guard, 65, he said they're worked on pulling a lot more this year than they did last year because they're going to run the counter both strong side of the formation and to the weak side of the formation. Last year they did not do that.
Second and one. Don't be surprised if Neuheisel goes double tight and then throws it into the end zone. He'll show a slot to the right, though. And this is James Kidd coming over here. Anderson going on deep right side. They'll throw on it. High lob. Lutz's incomplete. Now third and one, and they'll run for it.
Normally, on the second short, you think in terms of play-action passing, but not here in Colorado. They want to be more aggressive both offensively and defensively. And in talking with Coach Neuheisel, he said the one thing they're going to do this year is they're going to marry both philosophies, meaning they're going to be more aggressive on offense as they are going to be more aggressive on defense.
So for the first time, we see the I formation with Darren Fisk. One-time linebacker here at the fullback spot. He'll lead the way for Henry. Henry on a cutback. First down, Colorado.
Real nice job by Chris Nioli, the offensive right guard. He pulled around and prevented anyone from running up in through the hole. Now, a guy that size at 6'4", 300 pounds ought to be able to prevent a man from running through the hole. But first off, he has to get there. You know, a lot of guys in college especially can't move well enough to pull and get up in there. And you'll see what I'm talking about in this isolation. There he is, 65. He's agile. Boom. He wraps up that guy. He's knocking him back off the ball. You can run when you have a guard that can block like that.
Cougar defenders are asked to move the field too much. Henry in a huge hole to the 21-yard line.
They ran a quick trap up inside. Chris Nioli, the right offensive guard, pulled, and he pulled from the left side of your screen right here, and he'll pull and trap across. Very well done. Block back, trap, there's the hole, right up inside. Well done.
Second down and three. Now Kidd and Savoy are the wideouts. This is McCarty, and it's Henry. Huge gaping hole. Pounding to the 12-yard line. First down, Colorado.
Same thing, but they went the other way, Brent. See, they've got inexperienced defensive tackles inside playing those positions, and they pulled the left guard, in this case, Kyle Smith, 52, and he trapped the defensive tackle. You'll see him pull. Here he comes. There's boom, the kickout block right there on Delmar Morace, and there's the big hole.
First down, and big Lyndon Henry is a load for the Cougars right now. He got it again on a cutback, and he's running for daylight to the 4-yard line.
Mobile offensive line. That time, the key to that offensive play on the counter was Andrew Welsh, the left offensive tackle. He pulled all the way across the formation and sealed the play and allowed it to be a successful play. He'll be right over here to the left side of your screen, and he'll pull and seal. Here he comes to follow 74, up in the hole, bang, there he goes, awfully good job.
Second and two at the five.
5-yard line, it is second down and two for the Buffaloes. They lead it by a field goal, threatening now to score. Henry barges to the 2-yard line.
This is when they get in their three tight end offense, two tight ends on the line of scrimmage, and one tight end, Brody Hefner, as a wing back. And it's the only time they really use an I formation. The fullback in there, Darren Fisk, 43, is a lead blocker for their tailback. They like to use Lyndon Henry in this short yard situation because he's 6'205", a little bit bigger than Herschel Troutman.
Well, this is Henry's drive. He's been largely responsible for giving Colorado a first and goal.
He looked awfully good in their last game scrimmage prior to this football game.
Keith Miller steps in at fullback. He could lead the way here on first and goal. He does, short of the goal line.
See, what they tried to do is they tried to fool that time James Darling, the good middle linebacker. They sent the fullback one way and the tailback the other way, therefore not giving him an obvious flow read to flow into the play. It broke down, though, prior to getting to where that was effective on the linebacker.
Prior to his knee injury, Detmer was an extremely active and dangerous runner from that backfield. This being the first game since the surgery, you would not expect they would roll him much. He starts motion with the wide receiver. They come back with Troutman, the little back, and he appears to be just short of that goal line, which would leave Colorado with a third and goal. So early on, it could be just a touch easier for the defensive coordinators if they don't have to worry about Detmer on the roll as much as they did.
Left side line coming off the ball. Now big Lipsy there, number 88, 52, Kyle Smith may create room, but good linebacker fill there by number 20 is not a linebacker. That's a safety playing up in there, and he made a nice hit. Good job by Derek Henderson.
First quarter comes to an end. Buffaloes lead it by a field goal. They're threatening to score more.
No place I'd rather be.
Is
Some would say going 100,000 copies without an unscheduled service call is impressive. Sharp would say, it's a beginning. Sharp. Call for your free interactive kit of copier solutions.
My mama told me, you better shop around.
Most satisfied full-size pickup owners are Chevy CK owners. How do you know?
Like a rock.
You can see it in their eyes.
Like a rock.
Year after year, Sharp has been solving your fax needs. Maybe that's why we can still be reached at this number. Sharp. Call for your free interactive kit of fax solutions.
Welcome back to our studios in New York. I'm John Saunders. Back to your game in just a moment. But first, this update from the ACC. Leon Johnson busted through a hole and then watch the speed for the big guy trying to take it in for the touchdown. Just gets tripped up at the 1 yard line. He takes it in on the next play. Carolina leading Clemson 7-0. Brent.
John, thank you. Leon Johnson seems to me like he's been there forever. Here, Colorado leading by a field goal, third and goal. They go right straight ahead with the quarterback for the touchdown. Jason Leslie in for the extra point. And if there was any storyline to the first 15 minutes, it was the fact that Washington State defense was asked to be on the field far too often.
Boy, there's nothing tougher to do than play down four defensive line against a team that can throw the ball well through four quarters if you don't have a lot of people to rotate through the game.
It's 10-0. So a field goal and finally the touchdown by Koy Detmer on third and goal from the 1 yard line. Ray Caruth not very prominent in that attack. And Jack Caruth, anything wrong with the ace receiver?
Well, Brent, remember when Ray went for that great catch, gone to the sidelines? He got what has to be considered one of the largest rug burns I've ever seen on his right leg. Now what they did is at first they wanted to put a protective device on it, one of those like little rubber pads. He refused, but then he went out, ran in one play, came back in. He says, give me that pad. So he's back, he's ready to go. But I'll tell you what, that's one of the disadvantages of playing on the rug. It can burn.
Well, you know, he didn't practice on Thursday. He had a stomach virus and he was very sick, and they were really concerned about a dehydration problem today. Rick Neuheisel in the middle of your screen. As a head coach, he also is deeply involved with his offense. He has a coordinator, yes, but he works directly with him, and he's deeply involved in it. And Brent, this guy, the more you're around him, the more you visit with him, the more I think this guy is something special. You know, he does things differently and everything. He's young at 35 years old, a great communicator. But I saw him on the practice field Thursday. A guy made a mistake. He jumped him, and he sounded like Vince Lombardi. So there's two sides to his personality. I think this guy's got all the tools to go ahead and be a great one.
At Washington State, number six, Kevin McKenzie
and Morncola. Back deep. Ooh, nice game. Leslie whacks it. Coming out on the 20 with that one. No question about that. Good game. Little breeze coming off the Rockies here. Temperature up around, I suppose, about 80 degrees. That means that turf that Jack Root talked about going to get a little bit warm here this afternoon. Well, it's up to the young man from Great Falls, Montana, Ryan Leaf, to spark a comeback. And so far, his offense has sputtered here for the Cougars.
See, the advantage the Buffalo defense has is, as we said early in the broadcast, they're going to rotate 24 guys through. They have a lot of experience and a lot of talent on it, so they can remain fresh rotating series.
And they come back with Black, the running back. Blasting fumble. Washington State wraps it up, however.
So a slight loss on the play. Jason McIndoe falls on the loose ball for the Cougars.
See, the ball gets, they hand the ball up deep enough. He's just got to lock it up tight. He's getting really hit, and it's getting ripped out there to the right side there by Nick Ziegler, number 57.
Chad Carpenter being shut out, goes wide to the left. McWashington comes behind Leaf. That overloads the left side. Three wide receivers, and Leaf changes up the play at the line of scrimmage. Going to go high off McWashington, incomplete.
He's not getting a chance to really set up properly, plant, and follow through. Therefore, he's throwing the ball high. They ran a blitz up inside. They stunted. They didn't pick it up properly. And regardless if you're 6'6" or not, you still have to be able to set up and step into your throw. And he wasn't able to do that. Good pressure.
Dick, with the extra defensive back, they are hiding a safety. And they are bringing Black. That's the third time now that they have brought Black, one of the five defensive backs on the blitz for Colorado, and he is getting through.
Well, they plan to do that, so they're going to come after him. That's A.J. Kristoff. Their philosophy is to attack, attack. He's told the team, we will give up a big play from time to time, but my concern is not the big play, is how you handle it mentally on the next snap, the next series. It's, don't worry about it. This is our philosophy. We're going after him.
A little bit of confusion. The 11th man finally gets on the field now for the Buffaloes. Third and 13 for Washington State. Cougars down by 10. Leaf in trouble again. Jones finally picked up. Fires into the middle. Intercepted. First down at the 20-yard line. Torrey Davis picks it off.
Well, they love Ryan Leaf's ability to scramble and make big plays because he has the mobility of a 6'1" quarterback. But that time he shows a very inexperienced move right there. Makes a mistake. He's flushed out of the pocket, and he throws it laid down in the hole. And Davis, as you call it, just follows right back inside there, takes the ball away from him, and off he goes. See him, he'll just sort of bump into him right there. He has a right to the ball. He heads upfield. He's going to take it out of bounds. He's not going to get a shot.
Now you can expect the Buffaloes to be licking their chops and go early into that end zone. 13:56 left in the first half. Colorado leads it by 10. Detmer is out. The play's called on the sideline. Two wide receivers, one running back, and two tight ends. Their favorite formation. Kidd is off to his right and deep. Savoy's over here to the left. Great speed. Now McCarty goes into motion for the one tight end spot. And Detmer looks down. Wants the end zone. Cut! Drop! At the goal line by Savoy as they were thinking touchdown all the way.
Good defense, good hit by Dwayne Stewart, number 25, the strong safety. They went in motion, Brent, and the reason they went in motion is to try to get the defense moved to a three receiver side and then throw back behind it. And here he comes inside in the post move like that. He didn't have to back up because he had no area to defend. D. Moore and Cola, number 6, was right there at the safety. Dwayne Stewart came over and made the pop.
Ray Carruth checks in along with Chris Anderson. It's Carruth who will go to the slot to the right. Number 21, now on 2nd and 10. Henry, who's been effective at running back, still in. 7 yards deep with the call. Oh, right side. Barges now to the 7-yard line.
You know, sometimes you can be too aggressive and you can actually whip an offensive lineman and create your own running hole. It happened right in there in that play. The defender really got up inside, knocked an offensive lineman back, and the running back ran off that penetration. You see what I'm talking about right here in the middle of your screen. Good push-up field by Leon Benner, number 91, and then he just takes him and he runs right off that. Good read by London Henry.
Darren Cheverini in with the play, slotted to the right now. Kidd outside him. Savoy is to the left. 3rd and 5. Detmer looks right. Kidd's got it. Reaches for the goal line. Touchdown, Colorado!
Yeah. throw the ball over there. That was a secondary receiver on that. He ran a little hitch and then came back and then started again. Hitching just backed off him a little too much.
Jason Leslie for the extra point. It's a 17-point Buffalo lead here in the first half.
Plymouth Neon. Fun and affordability in four-door and coupe. The all-new Plymouth Voyager and Grand Voyager, the next generation of the minivan. And the new Plymouth Breeze, the sports sedan with fun for five. The new line of Plymouths. What'll they come up with next?
The Walt Disney World 25th anniversary.
Well, I'm ready to party.
Now at McDonald's, you can get one of four Walt Disney World 25th anniversary glasses, just 99 cents each when you buy any large sandwich.
You are looking at one happy little man.
Work boots. Tough on the outside, tough on your feet inside. Not enough cushioning. Dr. Scholl's Maximum Comfort work insoles give you 100% more cushioning. They make work easier on your feet.
It's country driving. It's fancy coat and tie. Ooh, it's the football team. Your beauty queen. It's why we're right nearby. And best of all, it's thrifty. Renting cars in your neighborhood. Ooh, best of all, it's thrifty. Coming through like you knew.
The Super Bowl champion Cowboys start the season in prime time against the big bad Chicago Bears on the season premiere of ABC's Monday Night Football.
John Saunders and Todd Blackledge here in New York, updating Illinois, Michigan. Scott drives back, thinking pass, but then has to run, Todd.
Well, he does a couple good things here. When he doesn't see anybody, he shows his ability to break some tackles and then speed in the open field, and that's why the coaches like him at Michigan. The guy just makes plays.
72 yards on the touchdown run. Michigan leading 7-0. Brent.
All right, John. Michigan, of course, one of the contenders for the Big Ten Championship, and a huge game for them a couple of weeks down the road when they come out here to Boulder. Wouldn't the Wolverines love to get a major of revenge out here? Nobody will ever forget the catch. One of the great moments in Colorado history. Here they're rolling, leaded by 17. They'll take a knee. Moore and Cole will kneel down right there, and it'll come out on the 20-yard line.
It would be good if they could establish some kind of running attack and tighten up those defensive linemen on their techniques so they're not always coming upfield thinking pass. It also takes a little pressure off Ryan Leaf, the sophomore quarterback. Easier to hand it off than read those coverages and throw it downfield, but just a little harder to move the ball.
It's been a tough day so far for the tackles of the Cougars.
They have Neon Taylor, the young receiver, and they'd like to go deep to him.
Quick fire complete. McWashington's free on that far side. That one of the more positive plays by Washington State. Rosga, the safety, comes over to clean up, but it's a first down on a first down pass.
Did a nice job on that. Have a good run after the catch. He saw where the defender was coming from. He gave him a little move, reverse pivoted, and went up the sideline. He was a high school quarterback. He wasn't a receiver. He's converted to a wide receiver position and demonstrating he has those skills.
Washington State 41-yard line. Tight end over to the left side.
Bringing fifth rusher. They picked it up.
Middle high incomplete, second and 10.
No, he's just throwing it too high. He's got to step into it. He's just throwing it too high. There was enough time to throw that accurately. They picked up the blitz properly. A little pressure on the left side, but to the right side, the blitz came, and they picked it up nice. You'll see a back to the right. Boom, he gets a knockdown there. Now here comes number 48 to the outside, and he puts some pressure on.
Terrell Cade gets a lick on him, and Ryan Leaf is being manhandled in the
this game so far. The Huskies were unable to get at him, especially in the first half up in Seattle. But here, Colorado is all over him. They're coming with a blitz again. One play, missed it, and stood up in the hole for a loss of a yard.
Woo! That was headache contact.
You said stood up, Brent. Oh, holy mackerel. He belted him. Matt Russell, boy, when he gets there, he's mad.
And Merkerson also into that hole for Colorado. Third and 11.
Merkerson also goes inside when they let arrest Russell and let they let him play the inside linebacker spot.
So now the three cornerbacks, as Damon Wheeler is in there with Davis and Simmons. In this five-man defensive backfield with Rozga and Black. There are four wideouts, now five, empty in the backfield. Leaf to throw, hit on the release, diving catch, that's a first down. And that is Carpenter's first reception of the game. Big one for Washington State.
You know, if he can hit a few downfield and get it going and get a little confidence and gain a little confidence in his protection, it's a little flat curl pattern. He comes back for it, right? He throws it low, right at the numbers. You can complete those, especially against that kind of coverage. It's a little bit of a zone coverage there.
This is a different kind of test for Leaf. This is a test of his courage right now, the way the Buffaloes are swarming all over him. Empty again in the backfield. Asking that five-man offensive line to hold up. Short drop, fire on the slant, McWashington free. He's going to circle back midfield, and that is a loss of yardage. Jackaroot, not only are they under fire here, of course, there's a tragic story involved with the Washington State offensive line, isn't there?
Well, Brett, going into the summer season, Coach Price thought he was going to have a great offensive line, but a couple of departures from the team, and then, of course, a major accident. Jason McIndoe was involved in an accident that killed his wife, Michelle, and the linemen were involved in it, and it really, really took these linemen down a notch. And Coach Price thought, let him get back in the trenches, let him get back focused on football. McIndoe's trying it from his left guard spot right now, but they're having trouble.
Now the officials, Jack, here stop play, and a timeout is being used by Colorado right here with the ball near midfield. So we'll take a break. Colorado's up by 17.
Started with a clean sheet of paper.
I want to see the paperwork.
If you'll just sign on the dotted
line. Put pen to paper.
It's a funny thing.
I want that writing.
That's a total write-off.
The most advanced, sophisticated, high-tech businesses are all built.
Looks good on paper.
Looks good on paper.
Looks good on paper.
On paper.
Let's get it down on paper.
Which is why you should bring your business to Office Depot. We've got all you need, all for the best prices, guaranteed, in writing, on paper. Office Depot.
This is where I take care of business.
Plymouth Neon Coupe with a zippy 2-liter 16-valve engine. Ride-tuned suspension, a 5-speed tranny, and 132 wild ponies. It's a pretty hot little number. Plymouth Neon Coupe, just $93.90.
Coach Vermeil, what should the Cougars do here?
Well, you know, they're being confronted with a five-man rush. That means six guys are in coverage. They're playing man-to-man. I think they've got to go deep and take advantage of that man-to-man coverage and go deep in the type of pattern. It doesn't take a long time to throw. Just the takeoffs. Just take off and run them deep. You hit one, you're back in the ballgame. If not, you drive them off you a little bit.
Second and 12 for Leaf and the Cougars. They show blitz again. It's Black again, this time picked up, but he threw behind the wide receiver, McKenzie.
Ryan is just not as accurate as he should be or has been on the practice field right now. This is a totally different experience than playing against yourself.
It seems to me that the changeup defensively and all the blitzes have rattled the young man here.
No question. No question. It would rattle an experienced quarterback because also they're varying where the rush is coming from. That time, the blitz came off a defender lined up on the slot, and he trickled in late and then came. Tough on him.
Third and 12. Show four-man rush. That's what it is. Leaf goes deep to McWashington, and he overthrew him.
He's overthrowing everybody. Now, that's a more difficult throw. That's not a high percentage throw. It was a beautiful pass, nice tight spiral, no effort to get it there, just not accurate enough. But you want to go against that. He goes to the slot man here, was singled up on an inside defensive defender, and he steps up in there nicely, and he throws it out like he has to. He gets hit late, but he has plenty of time to throw that accurately. He's got to make that one.
So Washington State's special team. Let's see if they can force a break. Here's Jeff Banks, their transfer to punt it. Speed galore for Colorado. Back to return, the freshman, Nunez.
A lot of confidence in the true freshman. Let him stand back there and return it.
Aims it high toward the end zone, and it'll be coming out on the 20-yard line. So let's take a look at what ABC's got in store for you tomorrow in prime time. America's Funniest Home Videos. Lois and Clark and Steve Martin in the movie L.A. Story. That's tomorrow here on the network. Zip. Colorado, ranked by everybody in the top five. And one of those schools given a chance to make a run at a national championship. But to get there, they're going to have to go the hard way. Tough schedule for the Buffaloes this year. And game in Lincoln, Nebraska late. Then a Big 12 championship game. Weapons galore. We've seen Koy Detmer here for Coach Rick Neuheisel holding up very well with that surgically repaired right leg. Flush from the pocket and down he goes at the 15-yard line. First time he's sacked today, and leading the way was big Leon Bender. What's the Bender story?
Yeah, Leon Bender is a guy that wasn't even there last year. He had academic problems. He was not eligible. He wasn't in school. He went off and he went to a community college, settled down, became a little bit more interested in grades, also got married, which was a stabilizing factor for him. He's a big, strong guy. He's back in school. He's eligible. He did a good job in his junior college classes, and he, as he demonstrates there, he's got the ability to play.
Your impression of Detmer so far?
I think he looks very poised and everything like that. Right there, he was sacked. It was not his fault. It was, they took the pattern away downfield.
And he comes back with the screen pass. And tripped up. Good defense at the 13-yard line by Brandon Moore. So here we've got 9:50 to go in the first half. John Saunders, what's coming our way at halftime here on ABC?
Coming up on Valvoline Halftime 96, we'll have the scores and highlights. Plus, I'll be joined by my new partner, Todd Blackledge, who's breaking down tape already as we speak, and he'll have a closer look at the top five. It's all coming up on Valvoline Halftime 96.
All right, John, we look forward to that. And here, one of your top five teams, Colorado, looks very impressive so far. A little bit of a sluggish start, but now they're coming on, lead it by 17. Detmer steps up, comes deep down the middle in the hole. Incomplete. Tremendous coverage that time. Dwayne Stewart, the strong safety, was able to get back on the play and defended the pass.
Well, he's used to playing center field, Dwayne Stewart, because he also plays baseball, Randy. He played a lot of games this last year, played in 32 games, hit 220. Here he's playing center field on defense and does a good job because Carruth, number 21, can beat just about anybody deep. These receivers as a group, believe this or not, I coached pro football for 11 years as a coach, never had a group of receivers with the speed that these guys have.
There was a penalty flag thrown on the far side.
Ineligible receiver downfield on the offense. The penalty's declined. It's fourth down.
And that means the Buffaloes will punt it. And Andy Mitchell in again. Had a fine opening punt. And now the Cougars will see if they could do something with a short field here with a decent return. Kevin McKenzie, who remember, turned one over earlier in the game. Standing back on the 44-yard line. They're going to set the return. They bluffed that they were coming, and he gets a tremendous Rocky Mountain roll. Touched it around the 20-yard line. The hat is down there. I think it's going to be up around the 20-yard line where Washington State will put it in play. So that roll and the inability to make the fair catch cost them about 30 yards in field position. So even the breaks
are not going Washington State's way. A 66-yard punt and a weak punt at that. How about that, huh? So now, let's take through next week's college football schedule here on ABC. It's a doubleheader day. Some of you in the Heartland, of course, are going to see Michigan State coming off their big win over Purdue today against Nebraska, Georgia Tech, North Carolina State. For those of you along the Pacific Network, USC Illinois will be your opening game. Some of you will also see TCU Oklahoma's your second game. And only on the Pacific Network, Utah and Stanford, the second game at the doubleheader. That's all coming up next Saturday on ABC. And if you want to see another one of those games, call your cable operator and see if they got pay-per-view. Or call DirecTV. Put one of them little pizza pie dishes up. You can see everything. Quick snap. Off here to the right-hand side now as Ryan Leaf goes to work to Chris Jackson, his first reception of the game. John Saunders, what's cooking?
Well, Brent, Illinois is on the board, and they do it with their defense. Scott Drysback hands off to Clarence Williams. He's hit by Cyron Brown. The fumble's recovered by Drysback. But Steve Willis is there to pounce on him for the safety. 7-2 now, Michigan's lead. Brent.
All right, John, and here Nyan Taylor, the speediest of the receivers for Washington State, is out far to Leaf's left. Leaf is now changing the play. His tight end's over to the right. One running back. He's going to go left side far and high again. Incomplete. Jackson, the intended receiver, and here comes the penalty flag. A late one at that.
That was one of the few times they only rushed four people that time and dropped the linebackers out of there in that nickel coverage. Ryan is still having trouble stepping into his throw properly and bringing that nose down so it's catchable. He's throwing a number of balls too high.
Against the Cougars.
Mike Price runs his own offense there in the center of your screen, calls the plays, head coach as well. He says his best football team is going to be in the middle of the season or to next year. This is an inexperienced group. It's going to be a good football team.
Pass interference on the offense. We'll replay second down.
But they'll bring it back further. That ball will be brought all the way back to the 16-yard line.
Now watching blitz.
They're going to come after
you
now.
You're going to come after you now. They go empty, so that's an invitation. You have no backs in the backfield to block us, so you rush five. It's five on five pass protection-wise.
Second and 16. That's McKenzie in motion.
Here they go.
Block. Leaf.
Said he did not plan to blitz other than on rundowns.
Favorable spot. First down, Colorado.
Concerned about blitzing and getting isolated one-on-one with the three and four receiver formations that Colorado runs. So he was going to blitz the rundown. That time he blitzed the passing down.
Now Carruth goes out wide to the left. First and 10 at the Washington State 37-yard line.
He's audible.
Henry again slams behind the right side. To the Washington State 29-yard line.
See, when you block the defensive tackles in a 4-3 and the defensive ends come upfield, there is a big vertical gap in there, and that JJ just blew up in there.
Chris Nioli, number 65, is the right guard. One of the best in the country, certain to go early in the NFL draft.
They better quit stunning inside. See, the guard gets on the linebacker, Darling, number 33, too easily. They'd be better off taking him on physically, Brent. Twice in a row, that stun has hurt him.
Second down and a yard now for Detmer. The overload left, four wide receivers. No tight end. Short drop, throw for the first down to the 25-yard line, Cheverini. A little closer than some might have expected. That coach at Bowling Green does a heck of a job.
He has done a great job. One of the youngest coaching staffs in the country, too.
First and 10. Ball at the Cougar 25. The 50-yard Trotman run. And Trotman checks back into the backfield. Herschel Trotman out of Naples, Florida, number 5. 7 yards behind the line.
They're coming again.
Detmer's flaring to him. Here's Trotman wide open down the sideline. Cuts free. Touchdown, Colorado. flag is thrown, but down inside the 5-yard line.
See, they blitzed over on that tight end side of that formation.
That's a 96-yard drive, and 75 yards of it would be credited with Mr. Troutman if this holds up.
Dead ball foul, non-contact foul against the offense.
Non-contact foul. Did someone swear at somebody?
Now, you would have thought.
Forced on the kickoff.
That must have been a celebration.
Yeah. I didn't recognize
it. See, the boys got carried away. They got excited. What a shame. Well, I was upset, weren't you? Oh, I couldn't stand it.
It really distracted me, I'll tell you that.
Oh, my.
That's the first game. And start things right by enforcing all the little things.
Working harder than ever. You need a truck that does too.
Don't move.
Introducing the all-new 1997 Ford F-150. With even more horsepower and torque, and all the legendary strength of an F-Series.
Better get to the Grand Canyon before we do.
The all-new Ford F-150.
Hold it. This isn't you, it's an older guy.
Oh, that was before I got rid of my gray hair with Just for Men hair coloring.
Come on, that's too natural to be hair coloring.
Just for Men. Apply and in
five minutes.
Just for Men looks too natural to be hair coloring. And now try Just for Men Color Gel for the hard-to-color hair of mustaches and beards. Brush in, rinse out. Just 5 minutes.
Long ago, an inventor came up with the assembly line, allowing a few people to make a lot of something. It was the model for efficiency. At Chili's, we pride ourselves for our inefficiency because we make each of the Big Mouth burgers by hand, grilled one at a time by a person. And when you taste for yourself how good they are, you'll appreciate all the time we've wasted. Chili's fresh grilled Big Mouth burgers, monuments of inefficiency.
Number one Nebraska hosts Michigan State, or Georgia Tech beats NC State. They kick off at noon Eastern in game one of a doubleheader next Saturday on ABC's College Football.
You'll see here Brandon Moore, linebacker, blitzes inside. All right, they pick him off. The tight end comes around and seals. Now the big tackle and big card come out and set up the screen wall. Very well executed, and they got the right coverage. Boom, knockdown, boom, knockdown there by big Melvin Thomas at 300 pounds, and in he goes for the score.
Jackaroo.
Well, let's update you on Kyle Smith. He's got a bruise back on the right side down by the kidneys. They dumped 5 pounds of ice down in that area. He looked up and said, I'm ready to get back in there.
Big kidney. 11:23 left in the third. He threw the block that started this hole, a 50-yard run from out of a deep hole. The freshman got off the hook in a hurry after stepping out of bounds on that kickoff, didn't he? High kickoff, this one to be returned. McKenzie, 20-yard line. Slants to the right, looks for daylight, tries to get to the corner. He'll be run out of bounds on the Colorado sideline. Well, let's check in on what the network has planned for you tonight. Those of you who missed the Beatles anthology last year, get a chance tonight to watch it right after Second Noah, here tonight on ABC.
It would sure help Washington State offense if they could establish some kind of running game. They did very little, as you can see by this possession graphic here. Right at the end, though, they picked it up, a 7-play drive and a 6-play drive, two nice drives out of the last three.
Try again with Black, maybe a yard, and that would be all. Navis in on top of him, Hannibal Navis.
Hannibal Navis. 6'3", 230-pound sophomore from El Cerrito. Had a great spring practice. They were very high on him when we got in here Thursday. We were talking to coaches. They talked about this guy. Has the speed, the cover back out of the backfield, the physicalness to take on the big backs and big tight ends.
Washington State has tried 14 times to run the ball, and they have gained only 9 yards. Second down, Leaf on the move to the left, almost picked off, and that has been his nemesis all day. Safety, Ryan Black.
They did a real good job of pass protecting. They took the pattern away downfield. He flushed to the outside. He set up nicely. He threw it. But when the quarterback moves parallel to the line of scrimmage, that pulls the defense as well. Now, you see, the big pass rusher is Jones, number 59. He doesn't rush. They go to a zone defense. They rush the outside linebacker and drop him off as a linebacker. Then rushes late and gives lunch to Mr. Leaf.
Intended receiver, so.
And I don't know how many balls he caught in junior college. He ran for 1,563 yards his freshman year, was an All-American JC. But I don't know how many times they threw him the ball. I even noticed in pregame warm-up that he didn't have the, you know, the real soft hands yet. And he'll develop those up there in that offense because they throw to those running backs.
I think one of the most impressive fellows has been Jeff Banks here today, the punter that they picked up from the junior college, as far as the Cougars are concerned.
Good high punt.
Yeah. Fair catch. There it is. 23-yard line. Nice to have a receiver with that kind of speed who can make the catch for you back there. Oh, that is a luxury. Let me check in the schedule again next week on ABC. Doubleheader Saturday now. Many of you here in the heartland, Michigan State against Nebraska. That Georgia Tech, North Carolina State game be out east, down the southeast. Second game, USC, Illinois, a big one out in this part of the country. Some of you will see TCU in Oklahoma. Then only on the Pacific Network, the second game of your doubleheader will be Utah against Stanford. So doubleheader next week on ABC. Change of possession. Koy Detmer, 3 touchdown passes today. And the way the score looks, 31-6. We'll see a lot of these Colorado fellows before this is over. Ray Caruth smoothly thrown out of bounds at the 33-yard line. There's a Big 12 game. Kansas State leading Texas Tech.
You know, Kyle Smith is back in at the left guard position, so obviously he's okay. You know, he had a broken foot a year ago, and he broke an arm, and he's had some physical injury problems, but he was sound. I talked to him the other day. He said he felt he was really ready to go. Oop. Leon Bender, number 91. Big 91, Leon Bender can end up being a dominating player if he'll take his academics seriously.
Dead ball. False start on the offense. It's still first down.
Left-hand corner of your screen, tight end McCarty right there. Move.
First and 15.
Boy, that defense had moved a long ways before he moved.
Savoy and Caruth off to the left of Detmer. Kid comes out to the right.
Screen.
Detmer to set the screen with Kaufman. And he's hit at the 32-yard line, almost back to the original line of scrimmage. Brandon Moore making the stop for the Cougars.
Well, Rick Neuheisel said they were going to incorporate more screen passing in their game. It helps slow down the rush. It also gets the ball to a skilled receiver, a running back out there behind good offensive linemen, spreads the defense out there. They had it if they just get one little nudge block out there.
Colorado State hosts Colorado next week at Fort Collins.
We sure had a good time when we went to Fort Collins a couple of years ago when they played Utah.
Troutman on a cutback. Slams to the 38-yard line, wrapped up by Darling.
James Darling did a real good job of coming off Chris Nioli's block. Chris was not quite as physical. He was just sort of brush blocking him. To the right side of your screen, you'll see Darling move over. He reads the draw. He steps up. Now, there's big Nioli. He's got both hands out there. Not being aggressive enough with that block. He's big enough. He should get pressure on him and knock him back. Darling has made a lot of plays, Brent.
Third and five for the Buffaloes. Caruth slotted right. Need to get to the 44-yard line for a first down, and there's the penalty flag being thrown, and this will mean they'll have to go a harder way.
Andrew Welsh, the big offensive left tackle move.
Dead ball. False start on the offense. It's still third down.
You know, when offensive tackles, especially on the left side, protecting the backside of the quarterback, have been lining up all game on a real good pass rusher, you're more apt to get him to move early in the second half than early in the ballgame. They start getting a little antsy when they see a good pass rusher lining up out there.
Ball at the 33.
Where's Brigham Young when we need him, Coach?
Boy, did they put on a show, both of those teams, last week.
31-6, Buffaloes. Detmer back. Firing first down midfield, puts it into Savoy's hands. Here's some more of that speed. 25 out of bounds inside the 20-yard line.
No pressure. Gave him way too much time to throw that football. That pattern took a long time to develop, Brent. Shouldn't get that much time. Maybe pass rush being tired already. They cross-charged inside, sometimes if not executed properly, and it wasn't executed properly. Big hole in there. There was no one in the quarterback's face. And here he goes, and Savoy, that 4-3-5 40 time. Tough to catch him from behind.
Speaking of that, take a look at this speed of these wide receivers. Look at Savoy, where he stands. Fifth on this list. They're the two freshmen ahead of him. Ray Caruth, incidentally, one time was timed in 4.17. Now, there's official time. This is Hartman. And he is stacked up at the 18-yard line. That speed, one of the reasons why Colorado has a chance to run all the way to New Orleans on the night of January 2nd on the Nokia Sugar Bowl. That's where they hope to determine the national champion this year. And this is some good-looking football team, Coach.
Yes, it is. But you know something? Personally, I think they should take advantage of the ability of that offensive line a little bit more and come off the ball in their zone-blocking principles and block people, get good line splits, and attack people straight ahead. Because when they do it, as I look here, they're very good at it.
Second down at 11. Detmer firing, using the tight end at the 15-yard line. Detmer is one of those quarterbacks who seems to sense pressure. He just feels it at the right time when he has to unload the ball. Can't teach anybody how to do what he does.
You know, if he'd held that a split second longer, he'd have been on his back, Brent. And that was Shane Doyle doing a nice job of coming around the outside of Andrew Welsh. He comes around to the right side of your screen. You see, boom, he lets it go. He knows he's going to get it. He feels that guy there the whole time. And you know, I've coached quarterbacks that didn't have that feel in the past, too. They'd get the bell rung and all these other things, and they're wondering where the guy came from. The good ones know where the guy is. Football awareness.
Third down and 8. 7-minute mark, third quarter. Colorado 31, Washington State 6. Detmer changes up at the line. Penalty marker is thrown. Anderson steps out at the 4-yard line, which would be a first down, but hold on because a flag is thrown.
What they really wanted, they wanted to throw a slot corner pattern, but the defensive corner sagged back on it and didn't allow him, so they took the short pass. Here it is, Chris Anderson taking the short one. See, he wants to pull the defender up and get the ball in behind him. They were running a pattern in behind him, but they couldn't get there because he held them off. Lawan Gibbons, number 31, did a good job.
We'll replay third down.
But the ineligible man downfield brings the ball back just outside the 20-yard line. So they get a first down.
Man downfield.
They're going to have to get to the 12-yard line, Coach.
Oh, I see it. The second man in the slot was on the line of scrimmage, and then they had the wide receiver on the line of scrimmage as well.
So it's 13 yards for the first down, 20 for the touchdown. Lobbing end zone, incomplete. Student body down in that section. Thought there was contact against Anderson with Terrell Henderson all over him.
You know, Anderson's a big guy at 6'4", 220 pounds, and they're putting him on a 5'11" guy right there. They're definitely, he definitely had his left hand on him. Terrell Anderson, number three, definitely interfered with him. No question. Those fans down there are correct.
Smart students here in Boulder. Jason Leslie. He made first field goal, first scoring play of the game. Put Colorado up by Trey. Rise got the safety. They put it down for a 37-yard attempt. No good. So the score stays Colorado 31, Washington State 6. Cougars ball when we come back.
The legendary Chalice of Malta has never come cheap. In 1238, it was captured by 10,000 Celts. In 1512, it took an entire armada. And in 1703, it took an arranged marriage to the daughter of Charles V, the older one. But luckily, if you want the Golden Chalice of Malta, all you need is the golden card of Visa, with extraordinary purchase power for extraordinary things. It's even mightier than the sword. Visa Gold, it's everywhere you want to be.
What did you eat this weekend?
A couple of burgers Friday night.
A couple of donuts.
Two tacos.
Barbecue ribs. Chocolate cheesecake Saturday night.
Some pancakes for brunch. Gee, that's funny. I should have exploded about an hour ago.
If you kind of ate your way through the weekend, start turning things around tomorrow with Kellogg's Special K cereal. Just 110 calories, not a speck of fat. Get those delicious, lightly toasted Special K flakes. Let your taste buds continue to enjoy. Start taking off what you took on this weekend. Make Monday Special K Day.
This is Ford Escort. Did you know that it's new? If you knew that it's new, did you know the wagon's new too? The engine is new, the suspension improved. A safety cell protects but stays out of view. It's quieter inside to shush out the out. But for those who simply must twist and shout, there's premium speakers on a new stereo, so you can get every note and get it to go. This Escort is great. This Escort is nice. This Escort has a very sensible price. So why not check out the newest Escort this season? We've given you every rhyme and rhymed every reason.
College football on ABC Sports brought to you by the all-new Ford F-150. Strength after strength after strength. And the United States Postal Service. Boulder, Colorado. Just a great setting here, and in our never-ending quest to find the best pizza in a college town, Dick Vermeil took me to the 14th Street Grill last night here in Boulder. Oh, a unique taste.
It was very, very different, you know, and we're sort of connoisseurs of that kind of stuff around these college towns. And...
First and 10 now for Leaf and the Cougars. Black is eaten alive for a loss of a yard. And Jackaroot, I dare say there are going to be a few more of those black buffaloes handed out to some of these defensive players this week here in Boulder.
Well, Brent, it's a brand new club that they've come up with based upon a Native American warrior organization. It's called the Order of the Indian Dog Soldiers. Now, this is the buffalo, but this is the Native American symbol right here. Now, in order for a defensive player to earn it during spring ball and in fall practice, he had to show exemplary integrity and also exemplary intimidation. When they talk about intimidation, they're not talking about trash talk. If they do well, you can earn this symbol. If you don't do well in a regular game, you can lose the buffalo for one game.
And some of those helmets crushing black at the 25-yard line. This will leave Washington State with a 3rd and 5. Dick, what's your feeling about giving, here we have a Terrell Cage shaken up a little bit. What's your feeling about giving the defensive players a goal like that on any kind of a team?
I think it's good. I think people take pride in it. And, you know, these guys really work hard in the offseason and spring practice and everything. And a little recognition for the guy that's done it more consistently and with more passion what he's doing here on the field. And like Jack said, you know, you can also lose this if you don't play well. You can never lose all of it. You can only lose part of the award. They can take the black buffalo off there. But I think it's good for morale. I really do. And I'll tell you, the coaches really believe in it. And they really do. You talk to A.J. Kristoff, who's really the coordinator of the defense and I think the stimulator of the idea. And
they believe in what they're doing, and yeah, they do what they believe.
Well, one of the things about this Colorado program, offense, of course, sells tickets, but defense wins championships, and you have to be impressed with the defensive performance today that he has turned loose with his unit.
No question. A.J. Kristoff said they were going to be more aggressive, just like the offense is. He said they had enough players to be aggressive and take chances because of the skill. He's not saying, well, we don't have enough of these guys, enough. He says, I've got talent here, and we're going to turn them loose and let them play. You know, they've been rotating guys in there. There's been guys in the ballgame, Grant, that I didn't have in my three deep, so they got a lot of depth.
Third and five, Leaf and the Cougars. Five-man rush. Over the middle, and could be a first down. It is.
See, when you give him enough time, and he doesn't need much time to throw that little slant in, he just gets back there and pops out with that little quick delivery.
McKenzie, the receiver. Ball out to the 31-yard line, and Leaf will start a fresh series.
He will grow a lot in this ballgame. As a coach, we always said players grow more during a season between the first and second game of the year than maybe at any other time the rest of the year. And I'm sure that'll be true with this young man's performance today. He'll be better next week.
Three wide outs for Leaf off to the left.
Jason McAdoo.
Left guard jumped on the play.
He's the young man that lost his wife in the traffic accident. Tough young man, an outstanding student. 3.2 GPA.
Ball start on the offense. It's still first down.
But it's first and 15.
You know, a guy that's been playing pretty well in there, Scott Sanderson, the big offensive left tackle. Everybody say he's going to be an All-American, one of the best four or five offensive linemen in the country. And so far, he's done a pretty good job.
Here is Black. He'll stretch it to the left. Battles his way to the 31-yard line, back to the original line of scrimmage. Well, there's been some excitement around college campuses today, and John Saunders has come up with the play of the day.
Indeed, Brent, the Burger King college football play of the day. And we go to the Illinois-Michigan game. Scott drives back, no one to pass to, takes off, finds a big opening, beats the secondary, and then good foot speed to the end zone. 72 yards on the touchdown run to give Michigan the lead. They're holding on to that right now. 10-8, that's the Burger King play of the day.
All right, John, thank you. We've had several exciting plays here authored by Mr. Koy Detmer in the Colorado Buffaloes today. Detmer with three touchdown passes. 31-6 our score.
Coming after him.
Leaf against the blitz. Throws incomplete.
Coming after him. See, he had to blitz, read that one and throw it quickly. They've turned two guys loose up on inside. They can only pick up one of them. He throws the ball, but not accurately.
Why don't they put a white jersey on Ryan Black? He's living in that backfield. I mean, can anybody hit number six here?
You'll see what I'm talking about. Right up inside. Here he comes. One right there. Now here comes the second one right there. Two guys inside like that. Remember, Ryan Black is a strong safety. And in the nickel coverage, he comes up and plays the linebacker spot, and they blitz him like a linebacker.
Third and 10. Very well-conceived defensive operation today. Defected, incomplete. It's punt time for the Cougars again.
That's amazing. A guy that tall. That's the second ball he has had batted.
That's Terrell Cade who is shaken up. And it is the left leg. That was Mau Mau deflecting that pass at the line of scrimmage.
You know, I had a nice talk with Mau Mau the other day, and I said, you guys with these different names are really tough to broadcast. He said, Coach, if you can say Mau once, you can say Mau twice, and you've got it.
Jeff Banks. Nunez set to return again for Colorado.
We're now talking about him. He's one of 11 kids. It's a pretty good sized family, Mr. Mushberger. 11. Imagine feeding 11 people. Hope they're not all his size.
I can't imagine the price of educating. He's got to turn them into all football players. Nunez made no fair catch, and that's dangerous right there. Down at the 26-yard line. 31-6 Colorado.
The job needs four guys now, and the guys need all their equipment. You're working harder than ever. You need a truck that does, too. Meet the all-new 1997 Ford F-150, the only full-size pickup with a standard super cab third door, 60-40 split rear bench, and standard dual airbags, plus a taller cab for more hat and boot room than ever. After all, the guys aren't getting any smaller. The new Ford F-150. Strength after strength after strength.
Something I want you to think about. Discus Athletic. Athletic, we're made for whatever you like to do. Like biking, football,
and for you Europeans,
football. One brand for every sport. You can't say that about these outfits. My, the unitard.
That is special.
Unnecessary spending.
20 yards.
So, no matter what your game,
choose
Discus Athletic.
One thing to wear.
But pick your colors carefully.
And it's getting better all the time. I'll stop the world and melt with you.
Well, Colorado has dominated this game so far. Coach, been a tough afternoon for Ryan Leaf and the Cougar offense.
Well, the offensive line for the Cougars have not been able to handle not only the one-on-one situation, but the variety of blitzes, the outside ones, the combinations of the one inside, you know, and that's a mature rush package that they're trying to handle in the first game of the season with a relatively inexperienced offensive group. They'll get better at doing it.
First and 10, Detmer fires to it. Receiver on that far side, James Kidd, makes a 12-yard gain. Jack Arute, how about the injured warrior for the Buffaloes?
Rocade will not see any more action today, Brent. They suspect that he may have a severely sprained right knee. Now, what they're going to do is they're going to splint the entire leg, take him back up to the Dal Ward Athletic Center where they have all of their training facilities, ice it down, and then they'll check it out after the game. But he's out for the rest of the day.
Lyndon Henry is the running back for Colorado. Gets the call. Upset with himself for not maintaining his balance as he gets to the 44-yard line.
Dorian Boos has been a pretty good football player all day, playing the defensive right end spot, number 90. He's not a good football player in Welsh, number 74, and he keeps working. That's the big thing as a defensive lineman. Don't hang up when the ball goes by you. Keep after it. It might be bounced back to you. He's made a couple real good pressure moves and passing situations as well.
Carruth back in, Cheverini out for Colorado. Second down and 7 after the 3-yard run for him. This will be a slot over to the left, and Carruth will come out split wide to the right. There are four wide receivers in this pattern. Quick pop, Carruth got it at midfield, one-on-one, turns the other way with that speed. Run out of bounds at the Washington State 40-yard line.
You know, you throw into a sprinter. You know, he ran on the track team. He ran in the 55 indoors, and he ran a 100-meter outside at 10-4. And, you know, and plus he catches the ball this time, and he can run well after the catch. He makes a move inside catch. Now he has the agility to come back outside, and that makes it tough on DeMar and Cola, number 6. Boy, what talent. You know, then you can play them a little tighter, and what do? They run a little move inside, turn around, and go up on you.
Ball in the Washington State 40.
Ruth slotted to the left-hand side now. Savoy and Anderson. They just move the speed right, then they move it left. Quick pop thrown behind to Carruth that time, and crawling all over him was Ray Jackson, but there's a penalty marker thrown on the play.
Brent, you made a good point. You mentioned that Ray Carruth was moved over to the other side. This year in the design of their offense, Carl Durrell, the offensive coordinator, and Rick Neuheisel, the head coach, decided to, rather than put him in one spot and allow defenses to zero in and double him, they're going to line him up in different spots and different formations all through every game. Can't zero in on him that way.
Penalty is against Colorado.
You can see how efficient they were last year, and they're not that efficient today, but not far off it. You know, scored 37 of 44 quarters played in the regular season. That's why they ended up with the second best scoring in the history of the team.
On the offense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
And virtually all the people that touched the ball offensively last year are back this year. So they're just more experienced.
Carolina big over Clemson. 31-0.
Surprises me.
So it's first and 15 for Colorado, leading Washington State. 31-6 here, late in the third. Detmer fires, got his man Savoy, who dropped it at the 20-yard line.
He had that one, and you know something? Detmer put it right, look at, he's grinning. He knows he put it right where it had to be thrown, right over that outside shoulder. Tight coverage right here. He gives him a little shake, comes off, see, sticks him inside, and then bursts up to the outside. Puts it right where he has to put it, right there. Just make the catch. It's too easy. I'll bet you he doesn't drop another one like that all year. And D. Moran Cola, number six, has his hands full covering a guy at 6'3", 200 with that kind of an ability.
Moran Cola now, playing a little bump and run on Kidd. Detmer under pressure, throws with pressure to the running back, slipping out underneath, and it's incomplete to Henry.
Detmer gets off, and he's looking right at Welsh at that time. I thought I read his mind and saying, what are you guys doing allowing this pressure? Here it is, right to the left. See, he gets hit right there. Again, that's Dorian Boos coming off the corner. Now, and Detmer got up, and he looked at Welsh. Come on, buddy. Don't you like me?
I think they ought to run the football. Okay? It's the last time I'm going to say that.
Third down and long. Well, Detmer will do just that. This is not what Colorado wants to see, but he breaks it off for a first down. Keeps going. Detmer inside the 15. That'll bring a huge ovation.
Be a little bit tired, Brent. I asked him the other day if he's with a new baby, if he's getting any sleep, and he said, well, the baby's been sleeping all night now, so I am getting enough rest. Real good protection initially, but good intense pressure by Delmore Moraes, number 93. It gets in there, right up on the inside. Now they flush him. Then he gets a great block over to the left side now by Chris Anderson, number 18, up at the top of your screen. You'll see it. There it is. He gets that good brush block right there, and off he goes. Good block by Anderson.
A 34-yard jaunt for Koy Detmer.
Last year, he carried the ball 14 times for minus 36 yards. That, of course, includes sack yards. You know, that's also got to give him a little confidence in that knee, too.
So John Hessler replaces Detmer, and with 2 minutes to go after the 34-yard run, leading 31-6, you'd have to think about giving Detmer the rest of the afternoon off.
I would think so. You know, this young man, John Hessler, had the highest pass efficiency rating in the Big 8 last year at 143.4. Did a real good job. His first start, he was 24-34, 5 touchdowns versus Oklahoma. So he's a poised veteran. Great Jack. To have those kind of guys.
Well, let's update you on Koy Detmer. The knee, folks, has passed the examination. He's just simply winded. I checked with the chief physician for the Colorado Buffaloes. He said, just going to catch his breath. We're going to give Hessler, have him go in there to spell. And he says, how about that knee? Held up good, didn't it?
It sure did. Darren Fisk is set now in front of Henry.
He'll probably play action pass out of it.
And Henry behind him is caught by Darling from behind. Number 33 certainly has been the most active Cougar. Had a dozen tackles at the intermission, and he's just adding to that total.
Here's a guy that's a zoology major. He wants to be a dentist, and he's out here in the field knocking people's teeth out.
Well, that's how you generate business. You hand him a little card after they're on the, come see me in a few years, and I'll fix that plate up for you.
Who was frustrated on that play, though, was Chris Nioli. He pulled out and got a knockdown pancake block, and the play was still thrown for minus yardage, and he gets up and he starts chewing on people. Come on, I did my job.
Going in from the 12-yard line. Hessler flips his turn. Back at the other tight end. Hefner also there. Henry. charges straight ahead and is stopped at the 10-yard line.
Super block by Aaron Wade. The offensive left guard playing in there for Kyle Smith really came off the ball that time and nailed him. You don't see many people dominate on the line of scrimmage like Aaron Wade did that time. Here he is at the guard position coming off man-to-man there on Delmar Moraes, and he, wham, and now watch him keep working his feet. Excellent, excellent technique.
Third down and eight, and we come into the final 45 seconds of the third quarter. Hessler brings the clock down to 3 seconds and needs a timeout, so that'll give us an opportunity to remind you about the return of Monday Night Football here on ABC Monday night. Yeah, we'll start a little bit early. 8 o'clock, there's an hour special. Monday Night Mania, they'll take a look at some of the great games past, and then they will open up with the Dallas Cowboys visiting the Chicago Bears, the season premiere of Monday Night Football at 7 Mountain Time and 6 Pacific right here on ABC.
You know, that Mountain Time people have an advantage watching those Monday Night games. That's why you're going back to Montana, huh? You're 7 o'clock, you're sitting there, feet up on the chair, watch a game. Heck, at home, it starts at 9 o'clock.
You know, we don't have a ban on cool ones up in Montana, Coach.
Oh, no, I know that.
Gotta come, Clay.
I'm going to change the subject on you, Musburger. It's 20 for 33. Nice job today. Did throw an interception in that first half, and they don't throw many. These quarterbacks over the years don't throw many. They only threw 11 in the season last year.
Three seconds remaining in the third quarter. Been a bit of a rout here, folks, in case you tuned it in late. Colorado sputtered just a little bit at the start of the game. Was up 3-0, and then the roof sort of caved in on Washington State, and helping to cave it in was the defensive unit of Colorado. They have been the major story and the major reason why this game has turned around. They have dominated the Cougar offense all day long. Now backup quarterback John Hessler rolls the pocket to the right. Incomplete. There was contact in the end zone. And that sure reminded the folks down there of pass interference, but nothing was called.
There was contact. They used a little rollout move to change the definition of the pocket to get out in front of the out pattern.
Now, it might not have been a play in which the pass was catchable. Now, that is very possible because that is a new point of emphasis this year on that rule. And if they do not think the kid had a chance, a legitimate chance to catch that pass, they are not going to call pass interference. That's the only thing we can think of right there is Jason Leslie. 1 and 2, checks back in. Here's a 27-yard attempt now for Leslie. Pounds it to 2 or 3. To 6, and one more look at this, Coach.
Well, he comes out on the rollout to get out in front of that out pattern. He's right out in front of it. It's a shorter throw that way.
That's a good call.
Yeah.
That's a good call. That ball was outside of the pylon. He wasn't going to get to that ball.
Yeah. Rick is talking to him.
There's someone who doesn't necessarily agree with me.
I can't believe you could call that. I ask him what he learned from last year or this year, Brent, and he said, the one thing I've got to do better, he says, there's no way you can train yourself to handle the criticism you receive as a head coach. He says, this year, I think I'll be a little bit better at handling it because I've been through it, and you are going to be criticized.
Looks like he's going to be one of the special guys in college football. You called it the other day, Coach.
Yeah.
Yeah. He got it rolling here, and of course, all of you are well aware of the story. He was passed over for offensive coordinator by Coach Donahue at UCLA, came up here, and then when Coach McCartney suddenly resigned, he was elevated to the position at the age of 34. Ran off 10-2, routed Oregon in the Cotton Bowl. Then Donahue steps out. UCLA comes to Rick Neuheisel, tries to hire him back, and he said, no, he said, I love it. He said, I bleed Bruin blue. He said, I love all those people down there, but I can't walk away from the folks up here in Boulder. And why not? They gave him a one-year deal with a reported $450,000. The way he's got it going, this indeed is going to be mission possible here in Boulder, Colorado.
Well, Well, he has two young children, a little Jack and Jerry here. He has another one on the way. That's a great place to raise a family. It would be tough for me as a student to go to school here and maintain concentration. You know, all the things they have going on. You look at those mountains with the ski, you know, the skiing opportunities, the hunting and fishing. Great place to go to school. And you know the other thing about this guy, he's one heck of a recruiter. Can you imagine a mama saying no to that guy?
Recruit the mother and forget the son. Leslie now whacks it high. Gonna come on out. It's Taylor with all that speed. But he only gets it out to about the 18-yard line.
Washington State hurt themselves badly with the turnover. You know, those two scores, you know, 10 points on turnovers, really in bad field position in the first half. I really believe they're going to end up being a halfway decent football team this year about midseason. These kids get some experience. They showed some flashes of being able to play well. You know, Mike Price is used to coaching kids. You know, he gets a good turnover there, gets a lot of JC guys, and he's used to bringing guys along and battling. He's used to being the underdog, and he and his staff do a real good job of bringing a team along.
Well, we can see the injured Colorado player. Dickey was shaken up on the play.
Is that Ryan Nunes? They have two guys with 22 on.
No, this is Dickey.
Okay, this is Dickey. He's the backup safety.
Well, this is a very good day for the state of Colorado. Both the Air Force, Colorado State, winning big along with the university here in Boulder. Maybe it's a good omen this weekend for the Broncos. 34-6, 16.
Oh, watch out.
Gonna set it into Black's hands. Black to the 30-yard line. And down to the 37-yard line, and yellow flag down, back by the 15.
Boy. Sean Jarney, a defensive tackle, jumped underneath the offensive guard, Jason McIndoe, I think it was, and got right in Ryan Leaf's face, but it was a screen-type play, and he just lobbed it out there and got it going. But boy, was he quick off the ball. Here he is, 94, the right side of your screens. He jumped underneath him right there, and he's right in his face, but he maintained poise and got it out there to the screen back. That's tough to do.
On the offense, we'll replay first down.
And it'll be brought back inside the 10-yard line.
Sean Jarney showing some real quickness. He's a true freshman.
Coach, I don't believe that Ryan Leaf up there at Russell High School in Great Falls ever looked at defensive speed.
No, I kind of doubt it, Brent.
So we've come to the end of the third quarter. Colorado with a big lead. Back with the final 15 minutes after this message and a word from our ABC station.
Inside your car's fuel system, there's a constant battle between good and evil. So if you have a dirty fuel system, none of these dark forces can match the power of STP Complete Fuel System Cleaner. STP's most technologically advanced fuel system cleaner ever. Dirt has met its match. STP Complete Fuel System Cleaner.
Someone figured out, together, we have 115 years working on Fords. My great-grandfather built the Model T. My grandfather built the Model A. My dad crafted the sheet metal for the Lincoln. Today, I'm an engineer on the Mercury Sable and the Ford Taurus. Growing up, I was taught, whatever I put my hand to must be done with the highest quality. After all, it has to live up to the family name.
The Double Grande Extra Foamy Vanilla Latte sound.
Just a coffee. Black.
Townies, regular Janes who like regular Joe. 2 weeks from Wednesday on ABC.
Maybe it's Denver or the 90s, but Saturday night isn't as simple as it used to be. Now you find the newest band at a movie theater. And the best theater at a church. No wonder so many people pick up the Rocky Mountain News Spotlight section before going out. How else would you know the best cheesecake is at a bookstore? By reading the paper that does. Denver's paper, the Rocky Mountain News. If you live here, you get it. Buy 6 months, get 6 months free. Call 1-800-892-NEWS.
Dodge Ram has won a lot of awards from a lot of experts, from a lot of magazines. But according to a survey of new vehicle owners by Strategic Vision, Ram is also winner of the Total Quality Award for Best Owner Experience in its class for the second year in a row. An award from the most important truck experts of all, the people who make the payments. Dodge Ram, the rules have changed.
A bomb scare shuts down I-70. Details at 5.
Mission Possible began today in Boulder, Colorado. The sights and sounds of a 34-6 lead as we start the final 15 minutes. Leaf fires incomplete. Carpenter, the intended receiver, on the far side. Dalton Simmons, who, like Koy Detmer, is coming off major knee surgery with coverage on that side.
You know, and he ran a 4-4 for the pros after spring practice this year, so he really is back. You know, and he's a good football player. He had one interception last year before being injured, but they're excited about having him back.
Second and 20 for the Cougars. A holding penalty brought the ball back inside the Washington State 10-yard line. Short drop, fires high, in and out of Carpenter's hands. And then John Saunders, what about that game back in Ann Arbor? The Illinois defense still holding up.
Grant, both defenses were holding up nicely in a 10-8 game, but then second and 7, Scott drives back 10 yards to Russell Shaw, just breaking the plane and finally getting another score on the board for the Wolverines, 17-8. Grant.
All right, John, thank you. Next week, Illinois goes home to host the University of Southern California, and in a couple of weeks, Michigan travels out here to Boulder. Well, football game, that figures to be. Third and 20 for Leaf. And the Cougars. Four-man rush. Leaf steps away from it. Fires incomplete. Tremendous coverage by their safety, Steve Rosga. And a penalty flag thrown at the 11-yard line.
There's a real good matchup war going on over here. The left tackler against Scott Sanderson against Greg Jones, 59. He has real good speed. He takes them all the way past the quarterback, and he just keeps coming. He just keeps hustling, throws the ball, and he's going on downfield after the receivers.
Good effort. Was he beyond the line? What's the situation here? The linesman threw the flag at the 11-yard line.
Could have been.
The punter is trotting onto the field.
Illegal forward pass on the offense.
Yeah.
Loss of down. Fourth down.
Exactly what it is.
When you can pressure like that and then cover like that, when the quarterback had the ball in his hands for a long time, usually someone will break free from man-to-man coverage. Not so in that case.
Nunez standing back near midfield to return this punt. And Jeff Banks, the punter, has really held up today. Nunez right near midfield.
Here's a real good test right here. Punting the ball out of your own end zone. Return. Pretty good job, Brent.
He did a fine job.
Yeah.
Drove Nunez back to the 43-yard line. Down at the 46-yard line. So we'll take a break. It's going all Colorado's way here.
If you ever take your new Pontiac Sunfire convertible cruising around some mystical ancient pyramids, make sure you try out that one latch easy opening top. It's a cool new way to worship the sun. Introducing the all-new Pontiac Sunfire convertible. Finally, a real set of wheels you can really afford.
Some of the most admired cars you'll see are owned by the guys who know cars best. They're ASC-certified master mechanics. And the number one brand of motor oil these guys use in their own cars and trucks is Valvoline, makers of DuraBlend, the leading semi-synthetic for a cleaner engine due to better control of harmful deposits. So use the oil the mechanics who take care of your car use to take care of theirs. Valvoline. People who know use Valvoline.
We have a wonderful 75 Lacroix Cabernet, or an exquisite 58 Le Bourse-Millon, or a 62 Je Vous Pinot if you're in the mood for...
No. Enough of that old stuff. The lady and I would prefer something fresh. How about something in a lager? What do you got in a Budweiser from, say, early this month?
Budweiser. Brewery fresh taste, strictly enforced.
And the Bears kick off our Monday night show.
Probably came to see his father play. There's seven married with children here on the Colorado roster today. Pops is having a good day. 14-35, it's 34-6, all Colorado. First and 10, Hessler in relief of Koy Detmer after his 34-yard sideline shot. Henrik spins free to the 45-yard line. Coach Rick Neuheisel, well, he's an active one. Volleyball games, ice cream after practice. But Jack Arutin, that was something that he tried to do himself this year in those pits.
Well, Brent, let me show you what a successful college football coach wears on Memorial Day at the Indy 500. Coach Neuheisel served with Buzz Calkins on his pit crew. And, Buzz, you're the IRL co-champion. How'd he do? How'd the coach do in your pit crew?
Well, he did great. Actually, about 5 minutes after he got into it, we had a little methanol fire, and he was there. We taught him to be the one to throw the water on us, and he did a good job of it.
We'll talk to him in a minute, Brent. Here's the play.
Methanol fire. There's nothing to mess around with. Second down, Hessler back, fires, complete. First down at the 30-yard line. Let me hear the rest of that story, Jack.
When we talk about that methanol fire, you cued him and told him what he was supposed to do during the fire, too, right?
Yeah, it happened about 5 minutes before. They coached him through it, and you can't see the flames on the methanol fires. And so when it caught on fire, everyone was telling him to throw the water on there. But it took him a little while before he didn't figure everyone was pulling his leg.
Now, will he work on your crew when you go to Las Vegas in a couple of weeks, or is he going to be kind of busy?
Unfortunately, he's got Michigan that weekend. And I'd like to try to figure out a way I could get back from Vegas back in here, but I don't think it's going to be possible.
2 weeks from tomorrow, right here on ABC, Brent, this guy's going to defend his championship.
All right, Jack, thank you. 34-6, Colorado. Rick Neuheisel finding it much safer over there on that far sideline hitting Buzz Pitt.
He called an audible, and they backed out of the defense they were in.
Middle's open. Cheverini incomplete.
He read a blitz coverage. They backed out of it, and they still got down the hole with their slot man down in there. Cheverini was the leading high school wide receiver in the state of California coming here. He had 88 receptions his senior year. Right down the middle of your screen now. He gets in behind the safety. Ray Jackson, number two, he gets in behind. Should never get in behind a safety in his own coverage.
Second and two for Hessler and the Buffaloes. Henry run the option with Hessler. And he's to the 26-yard line. And Brandon Moore, the 22, brings him down.
Jackson and Moore on the
tackle. Miami, despite losing a couple more players, big over Memphis today. Alabama tight, 14 over Bowling Green. And there's Kansas. Let's see, Kansas upset Colorado last year, didn't they? The week after that big Texas A&M win. That's by right. The Buffaloes. Air Force with 45 over San Jose State.
My alma mater. John Ralston, it's going to take time to rebuild that program. Plus, you're rebuilding it with freshmen rather than all junior college transfer, and that takes time. Looks like they're coming after him now. Yep, they are. They picked it up ever almost.
Battered at the 34.
Gary Holmes, defensive left tackle that time, got him on. See, when they bring linebackers inside, then there's no help for anyone. The guards have to take on those tackles by themselves, and sometimes you can get beat inside. You'll see Holmes right here will get underneath here. They'll bring the linebackers. Holmes 95. Now, that ties everybody up, and they actually turned out. Now, in my opinion, Chris Nioli, the offensive right guard, made a mistake and turned out. He should always protect your inside gap first, not your outside one.
Well, Leslie's going to try a long one here. About a 48-yarder. Rob's going to hold it.
Was good for distance. Anybody gets any kind of height there inside there might have been able to block that.
It's 37-6, Colorado.
You've been thinking about getting a digital satellite dish. And thinking some more. Well, think about this. The people at Radio Shack can answer your questions. Plus, now they've got great deals. Like a PrimeStar satellite system for only about a dollar a day plus installation. 95 channels of Prime sports and movies with terrific picture and sound quality. Think about it. Better yet, stop thinking about it. Radio Shack, you've got questions, we've got answers.
This is the Pontiac Bonneville, one of the world's most powerful sports sedans. The luxury of the driver's command center surrounds you with 12-way adjustable seats, steering wheel stereo controls, and a powerful supercharged engine, which makes it tough to get a good long look. So we're offering this free video information kit by calling 1-800-443-4444. Call this number today. You'll get quite a response.
Long ago, an inventor came up with the assembly line, allowing a few people to make a lot of something. It was the model for efficiency. At Chili's, we pride ourselves for our inefficiency, because we make each of the Big Mouth burgers by hand, grilled one at a time, by a person. And when you taste for yourself how good they are, you'll appreciate all the time we've wasted. Chili's fresh grilled Big Mouth burgers, monuments of inefficiency.
College football on ABC Sports, brought to you by Pontiac and your local Pontiac dealer. We are driving excitement. Valvoline, the number one choice of America's top mechanics. People who know use Valvoline. State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And Burger King, where you get your burger's worth. Lovely setting here in Boulder, Colorado. Dick, I thought Mr. Jackson told us that every time we showed up, we'd get a big sack of Burger Kings.
Yeah.
Have you seen any of those
no.
yet? Huh?
No, and you know, the other guy that was shooting off his mouth about us coming here was Chuck Ninus.
Oh,
I didn't
our
see
friend.
Him show up to take us to dinner. You know, the old president of the CFA, he said, boy, you guys come to Buffalo. We're going to do a number on you. Well, here we are.
Number, unless he avoided it.
Let's go, K-Mac.
You know, there is a legitimate celebrity watching this game today. Our decathlete gold medalist, Dan O'Brien, one of the really great athletes down there with Jack and a little bit. Coming up, we're going to hear from Dan. So happy to see him come back and win the gold medal after the disappointment of not even making the team in Barcelona. We had him over in Sweden, the World Championships. So this will come out on the 35-yard line. Give us a chance to go quickly to Jack Arute.
Brent, this is the closest I've ever been to a gold medalist, the decathlon champion from Atlanta. Now, you train right up at Cougar Stadium or in the Cougar area, don't you?
That's right. I live in Moscow, Idaho, and I train at Washington State, and it's really been a lot of fun for me. So come out here and support the Cougars and the, you know, the rest of the Cougars that made the trip. It's a lot of fun.
Now, the big question everybody wants to know is, are you going to remain active? Can we look for you to defend your title when we go to Sydney?
I think so. It's the best job I've ever had, and I think for the next 4 years, I'm going to continue to train. It was the biggest stage I've ever been on. I want to go back in 4 years.
Well, Brent, we've got it right here. Look for him again.
What I want to know,
under.
Jack, what I want to know is if Nike pays him as much as they do Tiger Woods. Coming up now, Dan O'Brien is a wonderful young man, and he couldn't be happier for anybody. First down now for Ryan Leaf and the Cougars. Fumble, Colorado picks it up, I believe, 91, jumped on that ball. That would be Mike Phillips if that's who wrapped it up. 91 was down there.
They never got a real clean exchange. I think Miguel Merriweather, number 10, the running back, was pulling away from the quarterback as he inserted it.
And I think along with it, there was a penalty flag down, but they're still changing units here. So
The ball will move to the left of your screen, and he inserts it there. Now they just pulled away from each other before they really inserted that key in the lock. See, and they put it on the hip rather than the belly.
Washington State, the 15-yard penalty.
15 more yards tacked on. Personal foul against Washington State.
New quarterback in there, and Jerry Weisinger. Now, this guy is the guy that actually beat Ray Carruth in a 40. He has run 4.27. Strong arm guy from Uvedale, is that right? Uvedale, Texas. Says he'd rather hunt than eat. He plays the right position.
After the penalty, coach, ball point down to the 20-yard line. So Colorado came in here favored by 3 scores, up by 4, solid 4, and threatening to add more. Then a big day for the Buffaloes. Here's their third quarterback, Jeremy Weisinger, and he's a bit of a runner, we understand, so we might see a little option look down here. And he fires complete now to the tight end. That's McCarty, who makes the reception. Jackaroo.
Brent, Jeremy Weisinger comes from the Texas area, so you know he's pulled for Dallas all his life. Take a look at a picture of when he was 4 years old. He tried to emulate his hero, Danny White. It got so bad that for one solid month, he told his family, don't call me Jeremy, my name is Danny White. He would only answer to Danny White. He said, someday, I'm going to be a big-time quarterback.
You know, the coaches here think he's going to be too.
But here's a chance for him. Second down and 2 inside the Cougar 15-yard line. And to the 9-yard line with Marlon Barnes seeing his first action. They asked Barnes to redshirt this year, but he has rejected that offer by the coaches, and so he will be used in the rotation. This is going against the Buffaloes, this holding penalty.
Last year he carried the ball 11 times. 6 scores. I don't think I'd want a red shirt either.
Holding on the offense. It's a 10-yard penalty. We'll replay second down.
Speaking of Tiger Woods, you can watch him wrap up his first stop as a professional on the PGA Tour here at ABC. Tigers 4 under. Final round coverage tomorrow, 4 Eastern, 3 Central and Pacific. The Greater Milwaukee Open presented by Miller Lite. 10.5 minutes left here in the fourth, 37-6. Weisinger on a short drop with time. Middle fires incomplete. That was Stiggers, the young man. Might recall, he made one of the few mistakes any Colorado players made today when he fielded a kickoff which was headed out of bounds and stepped out of bounds on the 4. Stiggers, like Nunez, is out of Texas. And great future here as they hope to replace Carruth and Savoy and Kidd down the road with Stiggers and those young men who come in. A great job of recruiting by Neuheisel and his staff this year. Again, rated in one of the top 10 recruiting classes.
They're very excited about that class. Very excited. Both offensively and defensively.
Well, there's reason to be optimistic about this team, Coach. This is as good looking defense as I've seen. Open up the season. Long time.
Here's a new wrinkle for them. Watch out.
He's a good runner. They come behind at the 10-yard line, but that's a first down, I believe. Let's hold on just a second. Robbie Meyer came and wrapped him up for the Cougars.
Good effort by Robbie Meyer because he rushed the passer first. They flushed him, get him out of there, and then he spins around and gets downfield. That's good effort by the guy. He'll be playing a defensive front 4 there, coming from the left side. Now they push him up. He gets up inside to go, and here he comes around the point. Shows he has good speed and intensity and desire to play the game. Good effort there, Mr. Meyer.
It is a first and goal right at the 10-yard line. Darren Fisk is set in front of Barnes in the I formation. A couple of tight ends. Anderson the wide out. Obviously before the snap.
You can run the option with him.
This is one of those tough spots for a coach like Neuheisel when he's got a big lead. How do you tell somebody like Weisinger not to stick that ball right in the end zone and get 6 more points? He's trying to impress the coaching staff, and everybody will say, oh, they scored, they ran the score up. I really can't buy that. And coming up, if we've got time, the thrifty car rental postgame report.
Still first down.
the third quarterback used by Colorado here today. Cheverini and Anderson, the wide receivers, go out to the right. Barnes, the lone running back, behind the quarterback. The issue hasn't been in doubt for some time this afternoon. Take by Weisinger, rolling now, has McCarty in front of him, going to take off to the 7-yard line. Second and goal from there.
Those misdirection plays are so tough on the defense. You start the full flow one direction toward the strength of the formation, the two wide receivers and tight, then you come back out and you're looking to throw the crossing pattern. The coverage took it away downfield, forced him to run the football, and they're forcing the right guy to run. I'll tell you, he's a good runner.
Jack, how do we wrap up the day on our guy over there, Koy Detmer, that we're looking at?
Well, make those stats. They'll be permanent stats because he will not return, Brent. He suffers from hypoglycemia, and the heat has gotten to him a little bit today. And with him being so far out front, they're going to play it safe. They're going to leave it up to the backup quarterbacks to mop up here today.
Well, that's a good line that he turned in today, and he sure looks fine. This will be third and goal from there. I think young Weisinger is determined to get it into the end zone himself, Coach.
Yeah, I know it. Well, he can both run and pass. He threw for over 1,600 yards and 20 touchdowns as a senior, and he ran for 1,400 yards and 21 touchdowns. Also, district champion and track team. He had over 22 foot as a long jumper. A skilled athlete. And a good student as well. They have a great story about him as a hunter. They said he was one of the youngest guys in the history of Texas to ever be arrested for poaching as a hunter, about 6 years old.
What was he, in the backyard with a bow and arrow or something?
Yeah, I guess. The coaches told me that. They're probably teasing me.
Nice again. Good job. Slammed by Boos. What's your opinion of Dorian Boos?
Well, you know, he didn't play at all last year. He was a medical redshirt with a broken left ankle, and he's come in, and I think he's been a factor. This defensive football team has a chance to be a good one. They really do, and I think they're going to be pleased with Dorian Boos when they study the game tapes. You know, he's played almost every snap. They haven't taken him out of there many times.
Cheverini brings the play in from the sideline. Neuheisel and his staff passing up the field goal here opportunity on fourth down from the 5. They've seen what they wanted to know out of Jason Leslie, leading by 31. They'll go ahead and let Weisinger see what he can do on fourth and goal. The Cougars, of course, very mindful of the way he likes to run with the ball. You got to hurry. The clock's going to expire. Not going to make it. Let me see. Did he get the timeout called? Yes, he did. Ooh, he was right on the number, folks. I mean, we'll take a break. Weisinger will talk about it.
Firebird waits. 305 horsepower comes to life. Ram air induction turns air into fuel in a rush. Firebird, you're ready to fly.
Just a reminder, next time you need a little help getting airborne, the 50,000 employee owners of United Airlines would be more than happy to help. Come fly our friendly skies.
If you take care of it, it'll take care of you. Your back should be no exception. Presenting Sealy's most advanced posturepedic ever for the back support you need. Only Sealy has a patented sensory arm that senses and cushions your movement, then responds to your weight with increasing support. Correct support. In the foundation, only Sealy has these patented steel beams, not wood. Help take care of yourself with Posturepedic support, only from Sealy.
At one time, Coach, 51,481, but not that many sticking around.
They quit selling beer in this stadium. Everyone's left early. Normally, they would stay here and watch the end of a Buffalo game, but the beer's colder outside the stadium as of now. Look at this guy.
In fact, I think he's looking at us.
He's scouting. That's a Colorado State student. That's what that is right there. So Sonny Lubick, I'm looking at the spacing from the end zone. No, wait a minute. He's got the binoculars trained on one of the cheerleaders. Come on, young man. Fourth down and goal, 6:53. Weisinger, one-on-one, lob, knocked away. There's interference, face guarding on the play. That's a fresh set of down.
Demoron Kola, number six. A sophomore from Richmond, California, De Anza High School. He's been a factor in the ballgame. We tried to pronounce his name right a couple times, I have.
Pass interference on the defense. Be an automatic first down from the 2-yard line.
Here it is, left-hand corner of your screen. See, he's pushing him all the way.
No question.
No question. And it, with the ball being thrown short like that, really made it tough on him because the receiver trying to get back to it. No question on that call.
Well, the Cougars are just begging for Colorado to walk in with another touchdown.
Yeah, I'm sure they are.
Lepsis. Barnes. So it'll be second and goal.
And Darling again. I don't know how many tackles he's made. We'll have to check on it. Yeah, he's popped a few today. You can see why he was captain and also all Pac-10 last year.
Two-yard line, second and goal. Weisinger picks it up. Rolls right, tosses back in the end zone, and incomplete. Hefner, tight end, is 86 working there in the back of that end zone, only that wasn't him either. That's another one that they've gone to, because I believe, Coach,
I don't that's have Averill. Him on my roster.
That's James Averill. Yeah. Fourth-string tight end.
Fourth-string tight end. I think he's coming off this position right here. Coming back and hold a block. He'll hold a block and then he works out there.
That's McCarty.
No, that was the wing then. They had him at wing. They're slipping these guys in off the bench that we haven't seen before.
That's why you do all this homework. You're supposed to know
it. Yeah, I know it, but my board will only hold so many names.
Third down and two. But there's penalty, yellow flag, loose ball. This
dead
is
ball.
Next week here on the
delay of game on the offense. We're still playing third down.
So doubleheader, and then there's our second game in much of the country except out on the Pacific Network. You'll have a Utah-Stanford game headed your way.
Utah's supposed to be very good.
Yeah,
Stanford supposed to be very good.
We'll have some exciting players.
They're going to have to be good to beat BYU, too.
Not the kind of game that Stanford usually loses, and then they
upset
they come back
someone
beat the team. Yeah. Third down and seven. The ball at the seven-yard line. Oh. Both coaches might want it. Burn this tape. This last 15 minutes, I should say.
There's Bill Doba, the defensive coordinator, with
dead ball, offside, on the defense. Still third down.
There he is, right in the middle of the screen there, talking to Mike Price. Very fine defensive coordinator, very much respected throughout the country. These people have put a team in a bowl game two out of the last 3 years.
Still 5 minutes and 56 seconds remaining.
We on the Community Standards Board
Find the new Burger King Bacon Double Deluxe. Indulgent. Yes. An excessive third pound of flame broiled beef, sizzling hickory smoked bacon, and hot melted cheese. Yes. McDonald's and Wendy's just can't match all that. Oh. Is that fair? Fortunately, this big scandalous sandwich is only for a limited time.
Only the Burger King Bacon Double Deluxe has more of the big, beefy taste you love.
The difference between children and parents is that children are the ones without a care in the world. Keeping them carefree and protected is the reason you get life insurance for yourself. With State Farm, you'll get a life insurance company that has always received the highest possible ratings for financial strength. And that can help you be sure that your kids will get to be kids for just as long as they please. State Farm understands life.
This is the Pontiac Bonneville, one of the world's most powerful sports sedans. The luxury of the driver's command center surrounds you with 12-way adjustable seats, steering wheel stereo controls, and a powerful supercharged engine, which makes it tough to get a good long look. So we're offering this free video information kit by calling 1-800-443-4444. Call this number today. You'll get quite a response.
Nine plays, five penalties.
This is JV's playing right now.
Third and goal, we think. Barnes fumble into the end zone. Cougars, but it was down, so it'll be fourth and goal.
It was Darling again, Damon. That's be his 21st tackle. Number 33 scraping off right into the hole. Two guys. Then he strips the ball out. Fourth and inches. It's one of the longest drives I've ever seen in terms of time and the fewest yards ever made.
Bryce again. Won't make it. Fumble. Loose. Picked up by Washington State. A free ball on the near sideline. And the big fella gonna rumble home. That's Dorian Moose. Don't pass out, Dorian. Let me see your spike, big fella. Let me see you do it. Tight to exhausted.
Oh, he is. He's been rushing the passer for four quarters. Didn't play football last year, as I said. A medical redshirt. Oxygen being administered.
Several bottles of it. Hurry, hurry, hurry.
Gives him a little lift.
He's absolutely passed out down here. You know who knocked that ball loose? That's Mr. Darling. Number 33 came in and...
You know, he may not be able to be a dentist for a long time. He'd be playing in the National Football League on Sunday afternoon.
Truant forgot what it's like to kick an extra point. So here it comes. Now watch Dorian, folks. Pick it up and start rumbling. And now, there it is. Boose. Watch Boose now. Here he comes, the big fella.
Darling is the one that knocked it out. He finds that.
Just like that, it's 37-13.
Onside kick.
If you ever end up in some Ben-Hur movie in your all-new Pontiac Sunfire GT, with its powerful twin-cam engine, you'll be glad you have a quick-handling sport suspension. And, of course, 150 horses. Introducing the all-new Pontiac Sunfire GT. Finally, a real set of wheels you can really afford.
For the very best in home entertainment, the place to go is Circuit City, where right now this RCA digital satellite system is just $199.97 after $200 cash back from DirecTV. Just sign up for 1 year of DirecTV's Total Choice programming, and the RCA DSS system is yours for only $199.97. Get more movies, more sports, more news, more channels than cable. Plus, get coupons worth over $200 from USSB when you buy any DSS system. Hurry into Circuit City today.
Todd and Celia Unger began their voyage together nearly 40 years ago. Today, they embark on retirement as carefree as when they first set out. That's because for the past 20-some years, they've worked with a broker from Dean Witter.
Respect the power of a client's dream and help them achieve it.
At Dean Witter,
we measure success one investor at a time.
He was chugging like a caboose.
Oh, he was a honking down there, wasn't he? You know, he was a tight end in high school and then went to Walla Walla Junior College for a couple of years, not playing tight end, staying as a defensive lineman. That's probably the first time he's touched the ball.
He's probably in the Washington State record book. That's probably the longest return for a touchdown with a fumble in the history of Pullman. I don't even know that to be the fact. Well, we will not have time for the full thrifty postgame report with John Saunders, so we'll give you as many scores as we can. We've still got a little time here at 4:44. Let's see, it's a 24-point Colorado lead right now, and we fully expect Truant to kick it over that they were practicing. He'll kick it over to his left, left-footed kicker, and they'll send about five guys down there to see if, wait for it, travel 10 yards and see if they can get it. Get it on a high bounce off the carpet. Here we go. Up in the air.
It's loose. Slide.
It's free.
Still free. And they got it.
State's got it. Cougars ball at the 41, and here they come again.
I've seen two onside kicks this year already, both recovered. One was in the Kansas City Chiefs game. It was as executed as well as it can be done. Here's another one right here. See, once that ball is touched, it's live for anyone. See, it went 10. It's live. And it's touched like that, bouncing around. And they got the skill people, the hands people in there, but they just batted it back to Morin Kohler.
He's played pretty well on that corner, hasn't he?
Yeah,
had one mistake back there. And it was first and 10, ball at the 40-yard line, 4:39 to go for the Cougars. Play fake. Gonna go long. Almost grabbed at the 21-yard line by Nyan Taylor, the speed merchant. Jackaroot.
Well, Brent, let's not be surprised by that excellent play on an onside kick. One of the things that the Cougar coaches did this year is they did away during preseason practice with emphasis on the special teams during the regular two-a-days. What they did instead was hold special teams-only practices every evening from 8 to 9 p.m. They felt that way they could put their full attention to special teams, and in that case, it paid off.
Second and 10. 4.5 minutes to go.
Coming after.
Deflected. Third and 10. So we come to the top of the hour with 4:28 remaining in Colorado, leading Washington State 37 to 13.
That's the third ball he's had batted because he's throwing the ball quickly and released to a hot receiver, and he's so close to the line of scrimmage.
Coming again.
Yeah, he is strong. They got to hold up. He's still up.
Well, he became a target when a quote appeared down here in Colorado. Brian Leaf, I mean, when he was quoted as saying, "We'll beat Colorado." Now, when the Washington State folks arrived in town, they said that's not exactly what young Leaf had to say. They said he said, "If everything goes our way, we'll beat Colorado." Strange that down here in Boulder they'd eliminate that.
And then get on the blackboard with all that kind of stuff.
Dead ball. Ball start of the offense.
So there's a big bullseye on Mr. Leaf's chest.
3 weeks down the road, you won't even recognize this guy between this game and the game he'll play 3 or 4 weeks down the road. He's got all the tools. And he's in the right kind of offense for him, with the right people coaching him.
425.
Here they come again. That's it. Step up inside.
Carpenter's got it. First down at the Colorado 32-yard line.
See, that time they pushed the rush all the way outside. There was nothing up inside, so he could step up inside there. Now, and Carpenter is the guy. If they're going to win football games, he's got to be the guy that gets the ball in his hands. He's on Dalton Simmons one-on-one. He beats him to the inside. It's perfectly thrown ball. But if they're going to win and be successful, Chad Carpenter has to get the ball in his hands.
31 yards to Carpenter. Carpenter now comes out to the right. Three wide receivers go out to the left, including Sean Timms, number 8. Carpenter, one-on-one coverage to Leafs right. Leafs look in that direction, comes back. Oh, almost intercepted, and that would have been 6 more for the Buffaloes. Damon Wheeler was the corner who let it slip through his fingers.
A true freshman out of Valley High School in Sacramento, playing in his first game with confidence. He drives in that ball. He just doesn't come up with it. And he can intercept balls. He did it in high school. Just batted that one away rather than picking it up.
A little stop and go on young Mr. Wheeler now.
Yeah. You know, he was a real fine running back. That's what he really was. Ran for 2,000 plus yards at the senior year. 11-yard average per carry.
He's one-on-one, bump and run on Thomas. Off a couple of yards, going to loosen up a little bit. Leaf going to use a safety valve. Incomplete. It'll be 3rd and 10. Merriweather out of the backfield.
He has seen so many black jerseys today all around. I mean, it'll take him a week to get over this one. He says, come on, guys. Just give me 2 seconds.
Michigan a winner today over Illinois, so the Wolverines go 1-0 in the Big Ten. They'll be out here in a few weeks. 3rd down and 10. 5 wide receivers. They've been coming on this package, and here they come again. Complete to McKenzie to the 30, short of the first down. It'll be 4th down and 7.
See, they just bring everybody and play everybody they can, man-to-man. And he elected to throw that straight pattern. Yeah, I think 2 weeks down the road, he'll throw, try to get to the post against that man-to-man coverage, because he had wide receivers going to the post inside, both slot people and the weak side receiver doing the same thing. But he elected to get rid of it real quick. Too many hits through the day.
Real education for young Mr. Leaf here today. Coming down to 3-10, 37-13. Here's the 4th down. Fire. Oh. Short of the 1st down, I believe. That was Ryan Sutter. Backup free safety with a stick. The Cougars think they've got it. Coaches of Colorado are upset about the spot over there.
They had him bracketed.
They gave it to him. That's a 1st down.
They had him inside and outside, so Sutter was just sitting there watching him. You'll see Sutter right here. The ball will be thrown, and just sitting inside. Now, here it comes. Oh, I circled the wrong guy. Excuse me. There he is. 3rd, 2nd, Sutter, and he is a hitter.
2:40 to go now, and a fresh set of downs for Leaf. Blitz throws against it, one-on-one, and an interference.
Yeah, obvious.
Now, that's not 1st and goal. It'll be 15 yards marched off here, but it will be an automatic 1st down, and there's still 2.5 moments. It is a 24-point lead, and the Cougars are moving toward the end zone.
The blitz coming right up the middle. He doesn't get a chance to set up. He just gets a chance to throw it high into the outside. And now again, that ball being thrown short like that, really tough on the defender. Davis doesn't have much choice but run right into him. The pressure will come from the right side of your screen. There's the defensive back, Rashidi Barnes, coming, number 40, coming right down the throat.
On the defense, automatic 1st down.
And the ball is put down at the Colorado 7-yard line. 1st and goal for the Cougars. Merriweather, the running back. Leaf, pump fake.
Would
job.
Wide open. Touchdown, Washington State. And it's Chad Carpenter with 6 points. And there are some folks loving that right now, and there's some others saying, I cannot believe it.
He did an awfully nice job. Did you recognize that he went back, set up quickly, and did a pump fake? He pretended like he was going to throw the slant pattern to Carpenter. He went into the slant, and then he wheeled around on that true freshman, Damon Wheeler, and just faded away toward that back of the end zone for the touchdown. Well done.
It's a wacky game, folks. Throw it. Misses the extra point.
Here it is. He'll go for the slant. In. Now he'll wheel back to the outside and go to the corner, and the ball was thrown perfectly. Actually, it took a little too long to get there, but he's picking on the right guy. Poor Damon Wheeler, number two, a true freshman.
An 18-point lead. As Leaf tosses the touchdown pass to Carpenter. 2:30 to go, and now will they come up with still another onside kick? Why not? First four.
Sure they will.
I've seen crazy, you know, on something like this, I've seen guys get loose, like Colorado, and the Buffaloes could run it back in the end.
I saw that in a pro football game.
Yeah.
I remember the name of the guy that did it. Can't remember many things, but I remember that, Malcolm Snyder.
Malcolm Snyder.
The Atlanta Falcons. They onside a kick, he's in the front, and he picked it up and ran it all the way the other way.
There's nobody there.
No.
Well, let's award our Chevrolet players of the game. I certainly don't think it's going to be a surprise to anybody that we're going to go with this outstanding middle linebacker here, James Darling. He's had about 22 tackles today. Koy Detmer, 3 touchdown passes, back from major knee surgery. Ran 34 yards, and then his day came to an end. So Chevrolet's scholarship program continues.
There's Mr. Darling. He is a darling today.
And they donate $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and to assist those in financial need. Chevrolet tradition for more than a quarter of a century. And Corey Detmer is Colorado's Chevrolet player of this game. Now 2:30, 37-19. Here it comes again.
It's a good bounce.
High bounce, tipped. This time Colorado will wrap it up, though, at the 40-yard line. And Mr. Sutter has been very active here, coming off the Buffalo bench.
He's a former walk-on that earned a scholarship. He won last year the Brian Cabral, who's the linebacker coach here, Special Teams Award as the most valuable special teams player. And he demonstrates why right there. Academic All-Big Eight in architecture. Good student.
Weisinger.
Another running back in there, man.
And then Hessler has stepped back into the fray. Let's go to Jackaroo.
Well, Brent, Coach Neuheisel says you've got to believe in yourself. He preaches that, and he says that's not egotism. And he tells a story about when he was a fifth-year senior at UCLA after replacing Steve Bono as a starter. Now, his mentor was Homer Smith, and Smith asked Rick if he thought he could complete 80% of his passes in a 7-on-7 practice passing drill. Rick thought about it and then said, 80% if you call the plays, Coach, 90 if I call them.
Well, he started out great, you know, that first year, and this is going to be a great football team. Like he said, though, yesterday, he said, the one lessons I haven't learned so far is the downside of this profession, going through those tough years.
Trap.
Charrington to the 40-yard line.
Here we go.
Final minute and a half here, ticking away in Boulder, Colorado. Well, it's a long, torturous road to Lincoln, Nebraska.
Villanova beat Rutgers, did that say?
Didn't see it, Coach.
I mean, new head coach, Terry Shea, right?
Third down of 5. Hessler. Sacked at 47-yard line.
Jonathan Nance. Chafee Jr. College All-American. He, you know, he made a good play right before the half. Flashed in and got a sack. That's a good transfer. Didn't transfer until this fall. He's gonna be a factor in this defense as it gets going. You know, and watching the Buffalo team play, what they came in rated number 5 in the country. Mm-hmm. To me, the defense looked like another number 5 in the country. I don't think the offense looked that sharp.
Agree.
Didn't you feel the same way?
No, I agree. Well,
it'll smooth out, and, you know, but the defense to me was more impressive than I thought I would see it.
So again, doubleheader next week. Many of you will watch Michigan State, Nebraska, and this part of the country. And now West certainly will follow up with USC at Champaign against Illinois. And your second game on the Pacific will be Utah-Stanford. That's next week on ABC. Final 45 seconds ticking away here in Colorado's opening day win. Colorado State next for the Buffaloes up in Fort Collins. Colorado certainly figures to remain a top 5 team. Andy Mitchell.
I haven't punted many times today.
Penalty flag thrown on the far side as the punt sails into the end zone with 38 seconds to go.
Yeah, that was only the third punt of the game.
For but they didn't have one blocked.
I know. Obviously, they spent a lot of time on it. No excuse for 5 punts being blocked. Mike Price, he's, you know, that guy, when we go to do his games up there or do games on the road, he's always very cooperative and helping in every way he can.
Illegal
good football coach.
On the kicking team. The penalty declined. Washington State's ball, 1st and 10.
Maybe that's why they haven't had any blocked. Come up with a new wrinkle.
Yeah. Well, we did Washington State UCLA last year, and his team stepped up and upset UCLA and played awfully well. And then they went to Nebraska the next week and played them real tough. Actually, we're leading 7-0 in the first quarter.
That was about it, though.
Yeah, and then from then on, yeah. They had problems and started turning the ball over.
Final minute, 30 seconds, and Leaf is going down at the 12-yard line.
She never gets at the end of a ball game with a ball in your hand. Throw it up there.
Time for 2 plays if they hurry. One more coming up. 6 seconds left. Washington working out of bounds at the 24-yard line, and this figures to be the last play of the game. We'll see. 6 seconds to go. Rick Neuheisel and Colorado win their opener. Set and match, Colorado 37-19. Let's go to John Saunders. Brandon.